forgetting. Pomponio estimates that each and every one of her kids must be 8 to 10 pounds heavier than anyone in her 2011 class, adding, quote, and those kids were pretty fat too.
Honestly, I didn't think it was possible that this year's kids could be fatter than last year's, but they are. I mean, short kids are fat, tall kids are fat, and there's a smell. I don't really know how to describe it.
Local dad Michael Corain navigated several discount travel websites today with a precision reminiscent of 18th century Viennese prodigy Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart composing a symphony.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. Welcome to the live Saturday edition of the program. You can join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. Also, the Porkfest Eve edition of Free Talk Live. And we have a special guest host joining us here tonight, Virgil Viduva. Welcome to the program.
Thank you for having me, Ian. I appreciate being on.
Yeah,
it's an
great,
honor.
Great to have you back. I think, when did we see you last? Liberty Forum?
Liberty Forum,
yeah,
yes.
Liberty Forum. And, yep. And, of course, you've been at Porkfest for how many years?
This is just our second year.
Okay, yeah. Number two.
We're newbies.
So it was definitely worth coming back to.
Absolutely.
All
yes.
Right, cool. We're going to talk a lot more about the Porcupine Freedom Festival over the next week. We're going to be broadcasting live from Porkfest, and it's a lot of fun. You can go to Porkfest, P-O-R-C-F-E-S-T.com. And that is where you can learn a lot more about this very exciting libertarian camping festival that will be going on in the northern White Mountains of New Hampshire, with over at least, probably I would guess, at least 1,500 people, maybe pushing 2,000 this year. The event just keeps getting bigger and more fun, and you know, more people are coming out. You brought the family up again, I take
it?
Yes,
yeah. Okay. The kids are going to party very hard.
So there's a lot of partying that goes on, as well as family kind of fun-style events, and it's really a blast. So go. You owe it to yourself to learn more about it at porkfest.com. You are also one of the people behind Truth Voice. Is that right, Virgil?
Yes, yes. We started this about 4 months ago, and it's going really well.
Yeah, no kidding. I mean, it seems like it's really blown up. What was the goal? What were you looking to do?
Yes. So the idea was really to bring, we looked at the police accountability news market, right? It's fairly saturated. We have cop block. We have, you know, the police. We have photography is not a crime. There's tons of organizations that cover police accountability type issues. So we just wanted to create a liberty-oriented, media organization that's self-sustaining. And we're hopefully heading in that direction, although honestly, you know, we end up covering more police brutality than anything else I'd like to cover. But I think we're on the right path right now. So,
yeah, I've been enjoying what I've been seeing over there at Truth Voice. In fact, Mark, you wanted to share a Truth Voice story here tonight since we have one of the publishers in studio with us.
Made sense. Like, he's already going to know. He knows the story intimately, right?
Yeah, please do.
Yeah, I got here. Five reasons why. Well, what we've police body cams are a terrible idea. We've talked about this here on the show, and we've advocated for police body cams. So this is written by you, Virgil. Police right. accountability advocates often discuss the importance of body cameras being used and worn by police officers. The argument would be that body cam use will lower violence and keep cops accountable. But there's is not enough evidence to suggest that body cameras worn by police will do much to help the general public. Here are five reasons why I believe the mass implementation and usage of body cameras for police is a terrible idea.
Terrible. All right.
Number one.
Because I'm kind of on the side of the police body cam, so
yeah,
interested to hear this.
I have been, too. I think that we should take all of it. As a matter of fact, not just the police wear body cams, but that the video be uploaded to the internet while they're on duty so that we can just all watch what our public servants are doing. And I also think the police should get a demerit every time they use a cuss word while on duty.
What happens with the demerits, then?
I don't care. I don't know. Dock their pay, whatever.
Okay.
$10 off your paycheck.
Spanking.
Yeah, whatever.
All right, so tell me reason number, are we going from 5 to 1 or 1 to 5?
1 to 5.
Okay.
It's not a countdown here. Facial recognition and expanded surveillance. There's a rich...
That's a good reason to oppose them.
It's among the best.
Yep.
There's a rich irony present in the statements of police accountability folks advocating for the use of body cameras by police officers. Why? Because they're the same people opposing the expansion of closed-circuit cameras throughout America's cities. I'm unsure how body cams are not, in essence, anything more than mobile spy cams. While permanently mounted surveillance cameras cannot be moved or relocated easily, a body cam worn by a cop at all times is clearly nothing short of a glorified and even better version of a surveillance camera.
It's probably true that, you know, the average person who cares about privacy may not be willing to wear a latex mask everywhere they go. I mean, there are ways to defeat facial recognition, but you have to probably go through some significant level of effort.
You're going to sweat a lot wearing a latex mask.
Right.
In order to do that. Yeah. So there's some concern there for sure.
And while the body cam technology is still largely in its infancy, it's expanding very fast, with high-ended cameras having many advanced capabilities such as GPS tagging of footage, fast dock recharging, and automatic download and storage footage on central police-owned servers. These capabilities can be easily expanded to be integrated into the NSA's PRISM program or another FBI program, where all footage collected by any cop in America throughout his or her shift could be automatically scanned and tagged by facial recognition software.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Yeah, I see no reason in the world why the Supreme Court would say that somehow police aren't allowed to use the footage that they get from their cams to sort of just track people generally.
Right, right. And remember, most of the footage shot by cops when on duty, if they wear body cams, right, most of that footage will be in public. So automatically, the whole privacy issue flows out the window.
That's right.
Right? You're in public. You have no expectation of privacy. Then once the footage is uploaded somewhere, it can be automatically processed by very specialized software, very fast. And then issue alerts, right? You know, a cop walked past you on the sidewalk. You know, Ian has a warrant for his arrest.
Yeah.
Ran into this guy. This is the GPS location. Let's go back, and track this guy down.
I don't think we're there on facial recognition software yet, but I suspect that we will get there. This is something, when we first talked about facial recognition software, maybe 10 years on the show, we just kind of laughed. Mm. But technology gets better over time, and Facebook can already tell who your friends are sometimes. And I wouldn't doubt that we're going to get to that point. Currently, people are upset because police cameras in cop cars are registering every license plate that goes through.
Not in New Hampshire.
In 49 states, no. But not New Hampshire. And basically just tracking people's whereabouts.
Oh, yeah.
If they get enough
And they've got them on the side of the road, too. I mean, it's not just the cop cars that have them. You know, they've got stationary ones on the sides of the road, so they can absolutely know where you are, even if a cop's not around.
Well, right. Most of the airport's parking lot, if you guys travel a lot or fly a lot, I do that for a living. Most airport's parking lots, when you drive in, they have CCTV cameras that will scan your license plates.
Yep.
And you know that is tracked somehow.
Sure. They're checking a database somewhere.
Right. They know who's driving in, who's driving out. They track your time, you know, time of parking and so on.
We live in a world today when the government knows what time you go to work, what route you take, where you tend to stop off on your way, you know, what time you arrive at work. I don't know what things are going to look like in the future, but this isn't the sort of information that a free society really expects its government to have. But it does, and it has it today.
So I realize this is going to sound ridiculous to some people out there, but if in a place like New Hampshire, where there's a surprising level of privacy advocates that are actually state representatives here, like to the extreme kind of privacy advocates, it wouldn't surprise me if these things were authorized in New Hampshire, but that they could put some sort of provision in that would prevent any kind of hooking up to a central database. Now, obviously, you'd have to trust them, and you shouldn't trust them. But nonetheless, I could actually see that being illegal for the police to do in a place like New Hampshire, where this is the one state where they have rejected those license plate scanners that you were talking about, Mark. So New Hampshire doesn't have that.
And real ID.
Well, yeah, real ID was a while ago, but the
license
plate.
I just want to make sure that there's an attitude here in New Hampshire of that, right?
So the license plate scanners was new, though. That was within the last year, I think, that was rejected pretty soundly by the New Hampshire State House. So I think there's a real kind of crew of state reps here that are really actually care about protecting privacy. And so I don't know if that one really applies here.
Well, another thing that people need to understand is 49 other states have a lawyer industrial complex in their capital. Basically, the unsuccessful attorneys in your state go on to be politicians because they can't make it chasing ambulances or whatever it is that they do. And those guys go up there and they make laws. Those laws, of course, benefit lawyers because that's the only language they speak. Whereas in New Hampshire, where we have 400 representatives for 1.4 million people, and the representative get paid $100 a year. The lawyers aren't chasing that. So what we have instead are citizen activists that tend to be the legislators.
So what happens when the cops get body cams, they sign up for these programs, but then we find out that the programs, let's say, you know, automatic video uploading management and all that, it's private. It's outsourced to a private company like Taser International, right?
Sure. And then,
that's outside of the legal scope. What happens then?
Well, obviously the...
Spanking?
The government can come there and take it when they want to, right? Yeah, that's a good point. Toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. We'll continue. There's four more reasons to oppose these, and that's the only five you could think of, but there may be more than that. So
probably.
If you've got one you want to share with us here, 855-450-FREE, you can join us. And also via Skype at Skype username lrn.fm, you can join us here on Free Talk Live. More coming up on the Live Saturday edition.
Are you suffering with hearing loss? Are you sick of people constantly complaining that your TV is too loud? Are you tired of asking people to speak up? Would you like to hear more clearly, but you don't want to wear a hearing aid that makes you look old? Then you need to try Listen Clear, a life-changing breakthrough precisely designed by top audio engineers to fit your ear almost invisibly. And you can adjust Listen Clear to find the perfect way to hear everything, wherever you are, and whatever you're doing. And right now you can try Listen Clear absolutely risk-free, with free shipping. We'll even give you free batteries for life. So call now. 1-800-940-5957. Listen Clear is lightweight and completely hassle-free, and it's practically invisible. Call for your 100% risk-free home trial with free shipping and free batteries for life. For free information, call now. 1-800-940-5957. That's 1-800-940-5957. 1-800-940-5957.
Honey, it's time for dinner. What are you doing over there on your computer?
I'm shopping for a new wallet. Mine is falling apart. Hey, did you know there's a company called ID Stronghold that makes shielded wallets to prevent electronic pickpocketing?
Oh, I didn't realize there was such a thing as electronic pickpocketing. What is that?
Well, apparently, many of the new credit and debit cards being issued have radio chips inside them called RFID that transmit our banking information to card readers when we pay. Unfortunately, a bad guy can also get one of these readers and go around the city scanning people, collecting their credit card numbers and personal information without us knowing it.
Wow, that sounds scary. Since you're getting a new wallet anyway, you should definitely get an ID Stronghold shielded wallet. Are they more expensive?
No. In fact, I can get a shielded leather wallet from IDStronghold.com for the same price or less than regular unshielded wallets from other stores.
Sounds great. My wallet isn't falling apart yet, but let me pick one out too. I want to be protected, and these wallets at IDStronghold.com look fantastic.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com. So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
We are back with more Free Talk Live, and you can join us here toll-free. Share your thoughts on police body cameras. They are a subject of some controversy, even within the Liberty community. We've got Virgil Vaduva with us from truthvoice.com, and there's an article, Mark, that you're sharing that you wrote, Virgil.
I did.
Five reasons to oppose police body cameras. And up until this point, I've been somebody who supports, reluctantly, because of some of these reasons, I suspect, although I haven't read them, so I'm hearing them for the first time here. But if you want to share your thoughts, maybe you've got some additional reasons or something else you want to share, you can bring up anything here on Free Talk Live. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Mark, there's a fundraiser going on for Peacekeeper.
Yeah, this week, Peacekeeper's launching its Indiegogo campaign for Peacekeeper 2.0. Last year, they released Peacekeeper 1.0, and this was really the world's first alternative to dialing 911. What Peacekeeper is it's an app that allows you, if you have an emergency, to connect with people who, in your neighborhood you care about, if you have an emergency, to send out like sort of a message about what type of emergency is, and people's phones all around you in your neighborhood will, that you've sort of connected with, will know. And this is really great because, honestly, it's those first few seconds. As a fireman, I can tell you it's those first few minutes that really make a big difference. And Peacekeeper can really help in those circumstances, especially if you're like right in the middle of it. Oftentimes you're trying to sort of put the fire out and, call the fire department and do those kind of things. And it's going to take them a few minutes to get there. Same with police. So check them out. Just go to pk.freetalklive.com. What that is that takes you to the Indiegogo campaign, and you can see what it is that they're offering there. They're trying to upgrade their app, which they've learned a lot from the first one, Peacekeeper 1.0. It's pk.freetalklive.com.
All right, so we're going to continue on the list of five reasons to oppose police body cameras, and we were on the first of those reasons, which was essentially that these things can be and probably will be in a lot of places turned into spying applications. They already, of course, have cameras on you everywhere, especially in larger cities. London, of course, is notorious for, what, 4 million?
Millions.
4 million CCTV, closed-circuit television
cameras. The technology already exists.
Absolutely. And we've seen stories about places like New York City and Chicago either implementing or considering implementing similar systems. I don't know how far along those are. There's been talk about having the government tap into private security camera systems. Again, where all that stands, I can't say I know. So if you're in any of those big cities and you want to enlighten us, feel free. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We also have Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. But the traffic cameras certainly have been around for a long time. And I remember going down to Florida, which is where I'm from, after several years of having lived up here in New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project, I was shocked and how many of these red light cameras had appeared all over the place, as well as other nondescript traffic-related, supposedly, cameras, spy cams that were everywhere. And when I left, they didn't have any red light cameras, so that was totally new and kind of a surprise when you're driving through an intersection and this flash goes off.
And technically, there's nothing wrong with using cameras to manage traffic, right? If there's a crash somewhere and if you have video, eyes on it, it's great. But you know very well they're not just using them for that reason.
Because they're the government, right? And they...
Governments love to manage information about their citizen, what they consider to be their citizens.
You're treated like a suspect, not their boss.
Right. Yeah, the approach of governments, especially since 9/11 and the NSA, and if you guys watch Citizen 4, for example, have you seen the film?
Oh, no, I've heard good
things about it. Fantastic, right. The approach has basically been we collect everything, so we get into the big data business, and the more data points you have, the more ability, the better ability you have to correlate all these data points and come to potential conclusions and even predict, someone's actions, for example. So the goal is to basically, implement something like pre-crime or, prevent terrorist activities. At least in theory, that's always been the case. I don't think there's any evidence that they've succeeded, but they collect.
Well, they only
everything.
Succeed generally in busting the terrorism that they set up. That story
Pretty
after
much.
Story, at least one a year, it seems like there's some patsy who gets set up by the FBI, who essentially gets talked into committing some sort of act that would be a terrorist act.
Well, the FBI claims that they're going to supply them with explosives or whatever it is.
The hotel room, the van, the explosives.
Everything. So the only terrorist, I would love somebody to call in and correct me at 855-450-FREE, but I can't think of any terrorist act that occurred on U.S. soil that was prevented by law enforcement, really, other than these things that they sort of manufacture themselves.
Right.
So if you want to share your thoughts, you're welcome to join us here. Are we through number one on the list yet?
Yes, we are.
Let's hit number two. Absolutely. This is the five reasons to oppose police body cameras by Virgil, who's in the studio.
Pairing the capabilities outlined above with the ability to tag video with GPS coordinates, police will easily be able to locate and track in real time to actual location of individuals of interest,
right,
especially during street protests or activities involving opposition to government activities. One of the things that, we see that protest has changed things in the United States and around the world, but governments traditionally don't like it very much. Even this one that supposedly has it in its constitution that you're supposed to be able to protest, they make free speech zones and they, you got to stand there. The police are constantly moving you to some different location. A protest in the middle of the woods is of no effect. You have to have your protest.
Most protests are of no effect, but, yeah, it's important to be seen if you're going to do a protest, for sure. Yeah.
Imagine a large anti-tax or anti-police protest taking place in a large metropolitan area where thousands of cops are live streaming video of participants' faces as they move through the city.
Mm-hmm.
Some protesters may not even live there, yet their privacy is being violated by the government agents simply through the use of advanced surveillance technology and video processing. Worse yet, as a result of participating in such protests and being easily identified, the participants could possibly be harassed in the future by police or other government agents. This is just sort of creating that that FBI file you've all heard about. Is, well, are you just a placid, doe-eyed, bovine citizen going about your day, or do you actually care about what your government does? If you do, you're liable to have participated in some point or another in some kind of protest action, even if it's not on the street, and stand up to some kind of government agent.
And let's not forget that they've labeled street protesters, the Department of Defense, they've labeled them low-level terrorists. So they do see us, people like us who go in the streets and promote protests or participate in activism, as terrorists.
Oh yeah, there's no doubt about that. There's been a long history of associating people who believe in freedom or who like the Constitution.
Oh, yeah.
I'm not one of those Constitution guys, but I used to be. Those folks who are more likely to say stand up for their rights as domestic terror threats.
I like the Constitution. I just wish the government, people in the government read it and cared about it at all. And since I realized that they haven't and didn't, and that they really haven't and didn't for 200 years, that's kind of where I just sort of parted ways with
it. So I wasn't too clear on how number two is really different from number one. Is it that it's GPS related in number two?
Well, yes, and really there's one paragraph left for Mark to read here, but really it ties into what the FBI has been doing for several years, and this is actually in place. It's FBI's NGI database, which is the Next Generation Biometrics or Identification Program. We can talk about that when we come back if you want.
All right.
Apparently, the EFF, the Electronic Frontier Foundation, has sued the FBI for the use of tracking and facial recognition records and databases implemented throughout any without any congressional oversight.
All right, we'll come back with more. You can share your thoughts on police cameras. Good idea. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. It's Free Talk Live.
Measles is activating on a mass scale, now due to the vaccines and iron poisoning. All symptoms, disease, and deaths are due to measles and iron, not just rash and flu-like symptoms, as the officials claim. Measles requires a host with iron to replicate. Iron intake is at an unprecedented level. Deaths and hospitalizations are set to soar now in 2015. This is the extermination plan, people. For further information, go to unveilingthem.com. UNVEILINGthem.com. Unveilingthem.com.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
Are you about to meet the media? If you're about to be interviewed, do their homework for them. Know this about the person who will interview you. He or she is busy, so expect minimal, if any, preparation. He or she doesn't know as much about your topic as you do. He or she isn't as concerned as you are about getting your message out, so you need to take responsibility. Provide a biography and fact sheet, photographs, or other materials that tell your story. Reporters won't be put off if you supply frequently asked questions. Remember, Public Speaking 101, at the end of the speech, what's the one thing you want them to remember? You can download the document I supply to reporters who interview me and squirm through a video that demonstrates how not to conduct your media interview at www.survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
SWCPoker.eu is Bitcoin Poker 2.0, where players can buy chips, play, and cash out anonymously with Bitcoin. No banking, just Bitcoin. Texas Hold'em, Omaha Hold'em, draw, and many new games, including Chinese poker. SWC Poker gladly accepts players worldwide, and over 2 million hands of Bitcoin poker have been dealt at SWCPoker.eu. Bitcoin Poker from the brand you trust. SWCPoker.eu.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Free Talk Live.
We're talking about the immigration situation here in this country. Now, Jeff, you have a five-point plan. I'd like for you to go over the 5 points again.
Oh, sure. Hold on. I just got to turn to the page.
That's fine. And there, if you, he's got pages worth of
Oh, yes. Number one, close the border. Put up a barrier on the border. And I mean
a barrier. Like a great wall?
Yeah, a great wall, barrier, stone wall.
Right.
I mean, something that's secure. And then you put a moat underneath.
A moat? Holy crap. Yeah, alligators in the moat?
All right. Now, you've got more, though, right? We got a wall and a moat, and then what?
And you can put sensors on there. The motion detector.
Motion, like motion tracking machine guns, too. Spit out some 50 cals at them if it moves.
Ninjas. That's what we need. We just need ninjas mounted at 10-foot intervals along this wall. The border ninjas.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM. If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Welcome back to Free Talk Live. We're here on the live Saturday edition, and our toll-free number for you to join us here is 855-450-FREE, and ExpressCoin is the best choice for getting your cryptocurrency, Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin. It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. There are licensed money services business. You can get your cryptocurrency with money order or check. Start off at ExpressCoin.com, whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, ExpressCoin.com. You can even do it from your smartphone by downloading their app. Once again, that's ExpressCoin.com. Coupon code is FTL, and that'll get you up to $40 worth of your cryptocurrency of choice with no transfer fee. So great way to get your first Bitcoin, especially now that it's up a little bit over the last several days. It had been down around 230 and jumped up to around 250, and now it's kind of at the 245, 240 range. So might
that, be bad timing. I wanted to buy some at Porkfest. So
well, maybe it'll go up. Yeah, you never know what's going to happen, right? I mean, it could go up again. Whatever. If you buy some over time, that sort of spreads out your risk as well. So ExpressCoin makes it easy. ExpressCoin.com. Don't forget coupon code FTL. We're going through the five reasons to oppose police body cameras by Virgil Viduva, who is in our studio tonight as he prepares to head all the way up to northern New Hampshire tomorrow for the Porcupine Freedom Festival.
That's
which
right.
Is where we're going to be broadcasting live every single night. We've gone through two of the reasons, and so what I've what I've summarized here is they could turn into spy cams, or will likely be used as spy cams, sort of fed into some sort of central server that's going to analyze the video for your face and see
facial
if you're
recognition
in some kind of,
software.
Yeah, see if you're in some kind of database of someone who hasn't paid their whatever tickets.
Well,
or
it's not just
there's a
that,
warrant out.
But they're going to get facial recognition of everybody and just essentially decide where the citizens, where you are, where everybody is at different times of the day, because people are pattern oriented.
Yeah, that's
so
true.
I mean, do you want the government to know where you are pretty much all of the time?
Well, the thing is, I mean, okay, so this isn't going to do that much that's different, right? I mean, we've already pointed out that the government guys, they've got cameras alongside the roadways, they've got cameras at the intersections. There are cameras in some cities that are stationary just wherever. And so that's already happening.
Just plus, more cams for him.
Plus, you're also, most people are carrying a cell phone at any given time.
Yeah, but you can get rid of your cell phone. You can get rid of your face. Right?
You can do that. If you're in a situation where you need to get rid of your cell phone, then it's time to go get a latex mask, okay?
Right.
Because even without police body cameras, there are going to be, in urban areas, there are going to be cameras around. And so if this, you know, if you're in a field in which anonymity is really important, then you don't need to be deciding whether or not to get the latex mask based on whether or not body cameras are installed on police. Like, you should already have the latex mask, right?
That much
because
is true.
You should be planning for this kind of thing. You know, your cell phone, of course, most people don't think about these things, but I remember there was some link that I found where Google will actually show you where you've been. Like, Google has you mapped already.
You
can even
opt out
see
of
it. Yes. I don't know if they'll opt. I don't think they're going to let you opt out of that. I mean, that's just part and parcel of having.
Opt out of knowing that they know.
Yeah,
that's right. All you opt
that's just,
out of.
Right. That's just part and parcel of having a radio transmitter in your pocket that is uniquely identifiable to you, basically. And so I pulled up the map, and oh, yeah, that's where I walked the dog the other day. And you can actually look day by day or over a period of days. And you want to see patterns, that will show you your own patterns. It's very, very interesting. I mean, it's interesting to look at, but the police
scary
would
too.
Find it interesting as well, right?
And as we all know from Edward Snowden, the NSA already has back channels straight into Google, so you know they can access that.
Yeah, and so, you know, that's all I'm saying here is I really don't think adding them to the police is going to do a whole lot more.
It will increase their ability. Why would you want to support that? Come on.
So, all right, well, we're only halfway through, or just not even quite halfway through the list, but I'll briefly answer that question. I support the police body cameras because I support having more cameras on police, even if it's their own. And I think that there are going to be some situations where if the police camera is there, that could make the difference between whether or not that cop can get away with telling a lie about something that happened. Obviously, we know they can turn the cameras off in some instances. I don't know if there are some cameras that don't allow that, so I'm not sure, you know, what all the different models are that they're using. So obviously they can still, and they've done the same thing with the police cruiser cams, right? Lots of departments have had these dash cams on their cruisers for a long time. And of course, we've seen them turn those off at suspicious times as well. Or, oh, where'd that footage go? Oh, I don't know. It must be a corrupt SD card. And you know, certainly that stuff happens, but it doesn't happen every single time. Anyway, let's continue on here with number three, Mark.
Footage integrity.
Or did we finish that last paragraph?
We did.
Okay, good.
Pretty much. Another issue of concern with the current generation of body cameras is the difficulty of maintaining the integrity of the footage recorded. Whether the footage is streamed or stored on the device, to my knowledge, none of the current devices in the market have the ability to prevent a police officer from turning the device off or erasing and modifying the footage.
Right.
These features have not been introduced due to cost, but also due to the backlash from police unions, who have largely been speaking against the use of body cams as a method to promote accountability.
So the police unions are against it.
Yeah, isn't that one reason?
That should be a
Virgil,
reason to be for it.
That seems like an indictment against this article here.
Wait until you get to point five. They all tie in together, okay? Come on.
A well-designed body camera would integrate features that will maintain the integrity and availability of the video, but not allowing a cop to turn the camera off. And by containing the software that automatically provides a cryptographic hash for all the footage recorded. You're the security expert, Virgil, and I'm not entirely sure what that stuff means, but it says, but basically you're saying it should have better security than it does.
Yeah, well, if you, a cryptographic hash is basically a mathematical algorithm that will calculate a hash for a file, which in most cases, video is recorded to a digital file. It maintains the integrity, and it gives you a signature of that file, and you know the file has been modified if these hashes don't match.
They don't match, right.
Yeah, so it's fairly straightforward. It's an easy and cheap way to maintain accountability, right? So,
because otherwise, in theory, some very technically adept cop could
absolutely.
Go into, and most of them aren't this, but somebody, there are some cops who are, could go into an MP4 file or whatever the video format is and tool around with it.
Absolutely.
Maybe make some changes.
Yep.
Erase some evidence.
Yep, indeed. It certainly could happen. Detailed access logs to the device should be a requirement, and also alerts should be issued when a user attempts to disable the device, open or modify the software on the device. These features currently do not exist, and it is unlikely that they'll ever be implemented. Ideally, if body cameras are truly about keeping our public servants accountable, all video from police officers should be available publicly in real time to anyone wishing to watch what the cop is doing during his employment.
Hold that thought, Mark. We're going to get back to the list here. First, Lewis is in New Hampshire, listening in our very own Keene, New Hampshire, to WKBK. Hello, Lewis.
Hi.
Welcome.
You know, I've been listening to all of this talk coming up recently about all of this, the computer, you know, monitoring of people and everything. Did you ever read This Perfect Day by Ira Levin? It was a bestseller back in about 1970.
I don't think any of us have. People are shaking their head in the studio.
No.
I don't think so.
It is absolutely frightening how it called on all of this stuff.
It was ahead of its time, is what you're saying?
Way ahead of its time. In fact, they had the self-driving Google cars in it.
Really?
And the government... The government was using the cars to limit the public's freedom of movement.
Because
the cars drove themselves, the government could just say,
Shut it down.
There's something going on here, and they would contact your car and tell it wasn't able to go.
Yeah,
and the cars had
there.
No steering wheels.
Lewis, thanks for sharing that tonight, man. I appreciate hearing from you. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's happening now. The whole you can control your car remotely thing, well, now so can the government, right? Like with systems, I don't know if it's OnStar that's offering this, but I suspect they will or do. And there are these systems that actually allow remotely a car to be shut down by some sort of command sent via computer or cell phone or whatever. It's in theory to stop a thief from stealing your car, and
yeah.
It certainly will be used in
if
that
a bank
way.
Robber robs a car in a Chevy, right? Like, you know, they OnStar can just turn it off, turn the car off, and then the cops are going to have a much easier time. Nobody's put in danger by a high-speed chase.
We will come back with more, and you can share your thoughts with us here at 855-450-FREE. And, of course, now you've got the Google cars, these self-driving cars coming up. So, again, there's no steering wheel in those. 855-450-FREE. More on the way here. This is Free Talk Live's live Saturday show.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
It's the end of quarter clearance sale at Lumber Liquidators. We're North America's largest specialty retailer of hardwood flooring, and we've got 10 million square feet of top quality floors for as much as 77% less than other stores. Get over 200 styles of real pre-finished hardwood from just 49 cents, 40 styles of beautiful bamboo from $1.59, plus deals on popular American and European laminates and more from an incredible 39 cents. And pay no interest until 2017. Hurry, clearance sale's going on now. Visit lumberliquidators.com to find a store near you.
More and more people are discovering the incredible benefits of alkalizing the body, and there's no better product for it than AlkaVision Plasma pH Drops. Packed with a powerful combination of the most alkaline minerals and compounds, just a few drops in water will rid your body of harmful waste and give you more vibrance and vigor than you've had in years. Now buy two bottles and get $10 off your order. Call 800-518-7615 or visit alkavision.com. Alkalize your body. Supercharge your health at alkavision.com.
We the People grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Hi, I'm Derek J. To me, an activist's calling is to actively work to advance a cause. The cause for which I work is personal freedom. I believe my life is best when I engage in voluntary interactions and self-government. I reject the idea that anyone else has a higher claim to my life or my body than I do. I see people who call themselves the government as a threat to my personal freedom. I realize you may feel differently, but my relationship with the people who call themselves the government is completely involuntary. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Did you know that Free Aid is a mutual aid, educational, and networking organization? At Free Aid, we support volunteers who provide first aid. We do outreach to the public about health and safety, and we bring together medically skilled freedom lovers. Free Aid is made possible by your generous support. Donors can receive great gifts like first aid kits, t-shirts, silver dime cards, and hoodies. The Free Aid Silver Dime Card Project is sponsored in part by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage, Freedom's Phoenix, and Don't Tread on Meme. Visit fr33aid.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can join us here. We're talking about police cameras, these body cameras that some are touting as the solution to our problems with out-of-control police. I don't believe that one for a moment. But I think that it can help a little bit, although Virgil Vaduva is with us from truthvoice.com, and he's got five reasons why he says you should be against police body cameras, although I would say one of the reasons to be for them is that the police unions are against them. So, you know, what do you got to hide there, guys? You know, who are you really representing there, police unions? Clearly, it's the interests of the majority of the police, which I don't trust.
The police unions are against good body cams. They are all about embracing the bad body cams. Yeah, absolutely. They want to spend a lot of money on them.
Well, we'll get back into that here in a moment. I want to also invite you to join us online. Just drop by freetalklive.com. And if you like what we're doing here on Free Talk Live, spreading the ideas of freedom as far and as wide as we possibly can. By the way, Africa will be back on board on July 1st. Most of Africa, a good chunk, huge swath of it. Via satellite. So we're spreading these ideas as far and as wide as possible, and you can help us for that with that for about $5 per month over at amp.freetalklive.com. You get perks like access to the amp-only call-in lines, the amp-only podcast, amp-only forum, and Facebook group. Go and get signed up for $5 a month with any major credit card through PayPal, or you can use Visa or MasterCard right there on our site at amp.freetalklive.com. So far, to summarize, Virgil, you've said these police cameras likely will be used as spy cameras, sort of nodes on a system that could be collecting video and scanning it for faces, facial recognition, that sort of thing. Of course, tie into GPS location, also the fact that these systems that exist thus far designed for police are insecure, meaning that, you know, any cop can pop the SD card out, yep, and throw it into an editor and start cranking away at the video.
Or power them off. It's already been shown at least two or three cases just in the last 6 months where cops have shot someone, killed someone, and then the cameras were malfunctioning or were powered off by the cops.
Super suspicious and no doubt about it. So, I mean, I'm with you on these reasons. They really make good sense. Mark, you've got the list in front of you there. Let's go to reason number... Are we done with three?
Yeah, we're done with number three.
Let's go to number four.
Truthvoice.com. Exoneration of police actions. Another problem with video footage is that we have observed many times throughout the years that video footage, no matter how damning it is, will often exonerate cops involved in wrongdoing. I've seen footage of cops involved in theft, lying, beatings, rape, and even outright murder. And many times these cases, the video was largely ignored by prosecutors who are often former police officers themselves.
I can see that.
Or by jurors who believe that police can do no wrong. With the nationwide cost of body cameras running into the hundreds of millions of dollars, the question on everyone's lips should be, why should we even bother with them if the footage is largely ignored? So I don't know if the footage is largely ignored. What I think is that there's a confirmation, there's a bias towards police and the expectation. I've had it for many, many years here on Free Talk Live. I've gotten tired of defending police actions. So I try to let the situation speak for itself. But I think that to some extent the value, Virgil, is that video can over time. This the sheer quantity of video of police, overstepping can beat up on people's biases, and
we have the amount today. There's go to copblock.org.
Oh yeah, there's more than you can possibly consume at this point.
Yeah. So just last year there was a teenager. I think he was a teenager in Utah with his headphones in. He was listening to music, walking away from a cop. The cop yelled out at him. He didn't hear him. The cop shot him in the back.
This was
on the cop's body cam. Nothing wrong. He was completely exonerated.
It's crazy.
The second case that comes to mind is
also happened in Seattle with a man who was deaf.
That's right.
Yes. Yes.
But in that case, and I didn't watch just because I saw the freeze frame from the video of the kid's body, and I was like,
it's traumatic.
I don't want to see. I've seen so many of these horrible police videos. It's hard to continue consuming that content. Every now and then I will watch one, but there were people who were really moved by that, right? Like there were people who saw that footage and were outraged at the behavior of the police. So we know that these departments are not going to change quickly because of the evidence. Obviously, there's a bevy of evidence out there of police corruption and police abuse, and the departments are really doing nothing at all about it. And that's what we should expect to see. But it's changing people's minds. It's changing people's hearts. And eventually something has to change because of that. And so that video did help that.
I hope you're right. I hope that's a positive. The second case that comes to mind is John Crawford, the black man carrying a BB gun in Walmart, where he was basically gunned down like an animal. The surveillance video from Walmart cameras clearly showed the cops just outright murdering him. And the video did nothing, to help. The prosecutor said, the cops did nothing wrong. John Crawford did nothing wrong, but they refused to bring any charges. So, again, that's another
example
of video.
There's a guy looking at an airsoft gun in Walmart and gets killed over
it. Carrying it around, and the cops show up and execute him right on the spot with an AR-15. So another example of video not solving any problem at all. And, in fact, all the police...
But it's better to have that video than to not have that video.
True. That much is true.
You wouldn't have gotten excited about... that's the video that got you into it, activism, right?
To a large extent, yes. Within the last year or so, yeah.
Well, then that's huge then, right?
Because
you've been a great activist thus far. I mean, you've put your own personal freedom on the line, having been arrested a couple of times, which
that's
we've talked about. Maybe we should catch up on those.
Sure.
Statuses of those here later on, and then also launching Truth Voice, and you've got the Greene County Herald, is that right?
That's right.
As well, so more of a locally focused publication, and so one of these videos, you never know who's going to see it, you never know who's going to be awakened by it. So more video, I say, is a good thing, even though there are some risks involved in this particular video.
But
let's wait for
third
number five.
That's a third-party video, though. Keep in mind, that did not come from a police camera. In this case, Walmart provided the video, so...
Number five, they empower crony corporate camera manufacturers at the expense of taxpayers.
That much is true.
One of the largest corporations catering to police departments throughout the world is Taser International. The company is mostly known for manufacturing of their electrocution stun gun devices, also known as Tasers, which have caused hundreds of deaths in the United States and probably around the world, too. The company now has seen the dollar signs in the body cam market and is pulling all the strings it can to further extort money from the U.S. taxpayer. With revenues of almost $200 million per year, the company is growing very fast due to the crony inside, in some cases, criminal arrangements with local police departments, police unions, and police chiefs. Taser International has quickly become the world's largest manufacturer and supplier of body cams for police departments, but they have not become leaders in the market through fair competition. Instead, their company has carefully cultivated financial relationships and ties with police chiefs throughout the country. An expose published by CBS News in March 2015 covered questionable practices involving Taser International, including hiring retired police chiefs as consultants and sending them on luxury trips overseas to promote and sell company products. The CBS wrote, as the police chief in Fort Worth, Texas, successfully pushed for the signing of a major contract with Taser before a company quarterly sales deadline, he wrote a Taser representative in an email, "Someone should give me a raise." This is what a police chief said. The police chief in Albuquerque also pushed for a no-bid contract with Taser International, which caused backlash in the community and prompted investigation by the inspector general. The Albuquerque Taser contract was worth $1.9 million. No bid. Police chiefs from Salt Lake City, Fort Worth, New Orleans, and other cities have been involved in highly questionable, likely unethical or illegal contract negotiations and signing with Taser International. New Orleans agreed to $1.4 million contract with Taser for 420 cameras and 420 cameras and storage. I'm used to reading it the other way around. A year after the contract was signed, the New Orleans police superintendent, Ronell Serpis, went to work for Taser as a consultant.
Yeah, sure.
So they closed the contract, you know, and as a payback, basically, he went as a consultant to work for them.
Yeah, oh yeah. There's a lot of big money out there. There's no doubt. And plus, if you think about the upkeep costs, too. So there's going to be there's the initial spend on the cameras. You've got 420 cameras. Well, these batteries can only cycle so many times, so eventually they're going to need a new battery, and they're constantly actually running through more than one battery in a day, I would imagine, because it could probably only go 3 hours or 4 hours or something. Yeah. I'm guessing on that one.
But how can 400 cameras cost $2 million? I mean, how many GoPros can you buy for $2 million?
That's a darn good question.
Right? Yeah, it's a really good question.
Well, they're going to argue that, you know, their technology is specially designed for the industry of policing, and so therefore, you know, you need to have this.
Sure.
Argue with fire department equipment, and it's incredibly expensive.
Sure.
And it's just stunning how much is spent on fire department stuff. And there is competition in that arena. There's all kinds of companies that produce fire department equipment, but it's all expensive. Really, really expensive.
It'd be interesting to see.
It breaks down on a relatively regular basis.
It'd be interesting to see what private companies are going with, like smaller organizations like the Threat Defense or Threat Management Center in Detroit. You know, what sort of technology are they adopting in this category? Our toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. I think there's a little more to say about this, even though we've gone through the five reasons to oppose police cameras. Let's talk about some of the reasons to support them. And I don't know if there are five of them. I really don't. It's Free Talk Live. More coming up.
It is the year 91,001 BCE. Witness humanity's origins in Hypercronius, a classic role-playing game for Windows PCs with a story like no other game before. The liberty-oriented experience that is not to be missed. Go to zog.ninja to get your copy of Hypercronius today. Use the code FTL to get $1 off. Hypercronius. ZOG.ninja. Code FTL.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or
go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938. Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, June 20th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.10 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,200 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $244. Antiwar.com reports the Yemen peace talks being held in Geneva effectively ended yesterday with the announcement that the pro-Saudi Hadi faction will withdraw from the talks and return to exile in Saudi Arabia, which is presently attacking Yemen with the goal of reinstalling them as the government. The talks began inauspiciously Monday with the demands from the Hadi faction that the Houthis surrender all cities in the country as a condition for discussing an end to the Saudi strikes. Yemeni Foreign Minister Riyad Yassin complained that the Houthis did not comply with any of their demands. It is unsurprising that the talks are collapsing at this point, as a press conference on Thursday by the Houthis ended in fistfights when the Hadi faction attacked them, throwing shoes at the delegate addressing the assembled media. The Saudis never really stopped their airstrikes during the talk and continued with the talks yesterday after the lack of resolution. UN officials expressed disappointment in the process, noting the Hadi and Houthi factions never even sat down at the same table during the 5 days and insisted the UN transfer messages back and forth. The only time they were even in the same room was during Thursday's brawl.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports the former CEO of a company that sells and operates red light cameras told a judge she bribed officials in Cincinnati and Columbus, Ohio to secure and maintain contracts with the cities. Karen Finley of Cave Creek, Arizona pled guilty Friday in U.S. District Court in the Southern District of Ohio to conspiracy to commit federal programs bribery and honest services wire and mail fraud. Between 2005 and 2013, Finley was CEO of Redflex Traffic Systems, a company that sets up cameras at intersections to snap photos of vehicles running red lights. She admitted she participated in a scheme in which the company made campaign contributions to elected officials in the two cities in exchange for securing red light camera contracts with the municipalities. Additionally, the company concealed the contributions through invoices labeling the payments as being for consulting services to a third party who then made the contributions. Columbus City Council member and current mayoral candidate Andrew Ginther is one of those officials alleged to have received a campaign contribution from Redflex Traffic Systems. Ginther released a statement Friday denying the claims. He said, "I had absolutely no knowledge of these activities and did not take part in them. While I am not subject of the inquiry, I have been asked to provide records that may help the investigation into Redflex. I've fully cooperated and will continue to assist in bringing these people to justice. In light of these charges, I have asked City Attorney Rick Pfeiffer to conduct an investigation into any current contracts between the city and Redflex." The U.S. Department of Justice said that Finley will be sentenced at a future date.
You can support FPP Radio by joining the Fans program. Fans are friends, allies, and Numeri supporters. Fans help FPP afford to produce more original content. You can join the Fans program for as little as $3 per month or any amount of Bitcoin per month, thanks to the recurring payment options provided by Coinbase. To learn more or to join the Fans program, visit fans.fppradio.com. That's fans.fppradio.com. Reuters reports a state board revoked the license of a former U.S. Army doctor on Friday, finding that he plied students with hypnotic drugs during battlefield trauma training and performed dangerous procedures, including intentionally inducing shock. The doctor, John Henry Hagman, was cited for training he provided in 2012 and 2013 in Virginia, North Carolina, Colorado, and Great Britain. Students testified on Friday that Hagman also performed penile nerve blocks and instructed them to insert catheters into one another's genitals. Assistant Attorney General Frank Pedrotti told the Virginia Board of Medicine, "The evidence is so overwhelming and so bizarre as to almost shock the conscience of a prosecutor who's been doing this for 26 years. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
A harrowing situation on Broad Street came to its conclusion Thursday night as a group of hostages were freed from local comedy club The Laugh Up Lounge after a tense 7-minute stand-up set.
Every once in a while, he'd grab his notebook, and I'd think maybe this is it. Maybe he's gonna let us go. But he just kept talking.
Additionally, The Onion recovered this video footage from the cell phone of one of the many captives.
Hey, sir, what
please,
do you do for work?
If someone sees this, help us. Please help
yeah,
us.
Yeah, micromanagement.
You guys are totally going to wang it out.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. No.
Cool.
I'm not a religious person, but at one point I said the Lord's Prayer, and it actually had a calming effect. Like, Jesus was standing next to me and said, "You're going to get through this."
I mean, sometimes you're just in the wrong place at the wrong time, you know. Don't take life for granted, because you just never know when something like this could happen. So.
This is the Onion News Network.
We're back with more Free Talk Live, launching into the second hour of the live Saturday edition, the Porkfest Eve edition of the show. In the studio tonight, you've got Ian and Mark.
Yep.
Also, Virgil the Duva joining us from truthvoice.com.
Thank you for having me.
It's great to have you here. You are back for your second Porcupine Freedom Festival, which is an awesome event that the Free State Project puts on every year, and they have for longer than Mark and I have been here. We're coming up on 9 full years here in New Hampshire. It's a great event. In fact, this is the 12th annual. What we'll be kicking off tomorrow afternoon is the 12th annual Porcupine Freedom Festival. You can learn more about it at porkfest.com, P-O-R-C-F-E-S-T.com. If we get the chance, I do still want to talk about that Uber story with nearly 500 Uber cars being seized by New York City police.
These aren't Uber cars. These are individuals' cars, right?
Well, that's correct, because Uber does not actually have a fleet. It's the individual drivers who drive their own car. We can talk more about that here in a little bit, but also wanted to, I guess, continue discussion about Virgil's article, Mark, that you brought in tonight from truthvoice.com about the 5 reasons why people should oppose these police body cameras that are being implemented in some markets, not all of them. I don't know what the current penetration is in major, medium size, or whatever, smaller markets, but you know, they may be happening where you live. You may not even be aware that this is a possibility or something that has been done where you live. So you might want to check on that if this is an important issue to you, because if you're going to stop these things, if you care about stopping them, then sooner would be the time to act on whatever politicking you need to do to try to have your voice heard by the city council, who maybe will actually pay attention to what you have to say, but don't get your hopes up.
Most likely not.
I mean, that's one of the things that you've gone through a great list here, Mark, and Virgil, of course, you wrote the list of why these things are a bad idea. I still reluctantly support them, and I'll explain that here in a moment, but you've come up with great reasons to be against them. I mean,
and a lot of people agree with you, Ian. You know, if you read some of the comments on this, people are calling me out big time. So especially cop blockers, they're all in favor of police body cams.
Really? I wouldn't think all of them are in favor.
Maybe not all of them, but a lot of them.
You're with cop block, right?
Right, but the people don't think about the costs. So the costs are really the biggest issue, you know. And
you don't mean the dollar costs. You mean the costs in your privacy, the costs in...
Both. Yeah. Both, right? So who's going to pay for them and who's going to give up privacy? And those are big, good questions, right?
Well,
so.
we know they're going to be taking a bunch of money from people and spending it on
exactly.
stuff. I suppose they could be spending it on guns and bombs, and you know they're not doing that. But all that said, your points are good. They're solid points. These could be used as spy cameras and likely will be tied into
right.
some kind of central scanning computer that will scan facial recognition to try to link you up with somebody who's wanted. for some warrant. Of course, lots of warrants are relatively innocuous. They're issued because somebody misses court. You know, if you miss court on a parking ticket, they might actually issue a warrant for you. You know, it can help track people via GPS. It's, of course, insecure. Video can help the police. And, you know, even with video of police aggression, it doesn't really seem to do a lot as far as holding them accountable. But all that said, of course, having the video of the police aggression is better
people
than
people get rich off of these.
Not.
A lot of people make a lot of money off body cams.
Right. The Taser International and these other companies that are manufacturing these things for police. So all good points. Let's go to your calls and thoughts on this. Alan is in New Hampshire, also listening in Keene to WKBK. Hello, Alan. You're on Free Talk Live.
Good evening, guys. How are you?
Welcome, sir. Great. Go ahead.
In your last segment, you took Taser International to task, implying a lot of wrongdoing on their part on numerous points.
No, we're not implying. It's clear that CBS actually exposed them for a lot of these actions.
Well, they enumerated how they operated, okay, but there is absolutely no proof that any of it is by any means wrongdoing. They are a free enterprise business. They're
Can you give before you go on, Alan? I'd like Virgil to give one example of something Taser has done, allegedly or supposedly proven now. Just to refresh our listeners who might just be tuning in. So.
Well, the best example is of the police chief, and I believe he was the Albuquerque police chief, where he actually, as soon as he closed the sale, he gave a no-bid contract, to Taser. I think it was a $1.9 million contract.
Are you okay with that, Alan? A no-bid contract?
Well, you know what? If it was a mutual agreement between the salesman, who happened to be a previous police chief someplace, and an entity that entered into agreement with him without coercion, there's nothing illegal about that.
That didn't answer my question. What I asked you was, are you against these no-bid contracts? I understand that it's legal to have a no-bid contract. I'm asking you, Alan, how you feel about it.
Well, it depends on whether or not there are other people in the market who are competitive with the product that's being offered.
Are there other competitors, Virgil, besides Taser?
I'm pretty sure that a GoPro camera that's cost $300 at Walmart or Target is better than a Taser-made camera.
Yeah, so there are other competitors in the marketplace, and they weren't given a chance to even bid on that. I mean, that's good old boy cronyism, isn't it? You support that?
Well, I don't know if that is. Are you opposed to free enterprise?
Free enterprise isn't a no bid contract. Where do you live?
And this is
kind of cronyism in India or something like that. No, I am for free enterprise. I am against no bid contracts.
You absolutely have no idea whether or not their product is superior or inferior to anything that's
in the market.
How would we know?
Exactly.
Since there's no competition, sir.
Well,
free marketplaces have competition so that we find out if products are superior or not. In an area where you have no bid contracts, you'll never find out what's better.
Well, maybe to your satisfaction, but maybe the people who
to the satisfaction of the people who are being taxed. You said that there was no coercion here.
The purchase can make that decision for themselves.
No, they cannot, because they're taking my tax money at the threat of my home. You said there was no coercion, and I will remind you that they will kick me and my family out on the street if I don't pay property taxes. To suggest that this money belongs to the police chief is just the kind of boot licking that takes this country into fascism.
What the heck does that have to do with buying cameras?
The cameras are bought with tax money. Do I have to take you all the way down the primrose path?
Apparently you do, Mark.
So
you're a damn lunatic. You know that? I'm a damn lunatic.
Okay, what's lunatic about my point?
What's crazy about wanting bids on a contract? He hung up. Yeah. What's crazy about wanting bids on a contract?
Nothing. I mean, when you're obviously a police chief or a person who works for Taser.
I have never heard anyone defend no-bid contracts before.
Well, he's acting as if the money, this $1.9 million, belongs to the police chief himself. And that would be okay if this is money. But it's not. Yeah, that's the problem.
It's taxpayer dollars. And sort of one of the basic things that a government should do to try to at least appear legitimate.
Right.
Like on the show, we know that governments are not legitimate. They're, you know, gangs of men and women who will force their way upon people, whether they like it or not. And they'll use the threat and actual violence to get their way. I mean, we understand that. But governments, it's very important to them, at least it should be, important to them to put on this auspice of fairness and, you know, to make it appear as though they've done some level of due diligence with the people's yep. money that they've taken by threat of force.
And to suggest that sending these police chiefs on luxury cruises and hiring them as consultants immediately after they sign a contract and when they retire, to suggest there's no connection between these events, it's silly. Come on.
You mean a contractor that just happens to have been a police chief in the past,
right.
giving another giving a customer who is a police chief a trip to Cancun is somehow not the free market?
Complete coincidence. Contract? It just happened. It's
ridiculous.
Yeah, I've never heard anybody take the side of a no bid contract being handed
out. It's not just a no bid contract. It'd be one thing if it was a no bid contract, but it's so much more than that.
Yep.
So you can share your thoughts here, just like Alan did. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE.
Maybe I missed it completely.
Do you mean? What did you miss?
Look, that's what I'm asking the listeners. At 855-450-FREE.
You mean you missed his point?
Explain to me how a no-bid contract is the free market. How a police chief should be able to spend their money however they wish, and that the public, whose money it was originally, in some way should just sanctify this.
Yeah, Mark's face was very red, so you guys.
Well, yes. I couldn't believe the man.
I had to turn the webcam around.
Yep, I noticed
Mark.
That.
All right, so if you want to call in to answer Mark's inquiry there, our number is 855-450-FREE. Maybe you're on Alan's side. Maybe you think that police departments should be able to just hand out contracts without taking any other bids from anyone else. Good old boy network all the way, 855-450-FREE, because that's the way it's always been, and that's the way it should be, right? We also have Skype. You can Skype into the show here at username lrn.fm. We got more coming up here on the live Saturday edition of Free Talk Live.
I'm Steve Sitkowski, a former Wall Street insider. I'm holding a book that will show you investing strategies which could help you earn the kind of money you've always dreamed about. And right now, I'm giving this book away for free. So who needs to read it? If you're in the middle of your career and worry you'll never have enough money to retire, you need to read this book. If you're already retired and your income isn't enough, you need to read this book. And if you don't want to be selling burgers at 80, you need to read this free book. It includes the strategy I use to make a 72% profit on a trade where the stock only moved 12%. You'll need at least $1 million to ever fully retire. If you're behind on that goal, you really need to read Trade Like the Pros. And you can for free by calling 1-800-944-5836. Skeptical that it will deliver results? It's a free book, so what do you have to lose? Find out how at 1-800-944-5836. 1-800-944-5836.
We live in a complicated society. Stressful issues are always popping up. Have you ever been treated unfairly by someone? Have you ever been overcharged for a repair? Have you ever signed a contract or a document worried about identity theft? How many times have you been in those unique situations where you just wanted to call an attorney to find out if you're right or wrong, or what your legal rights are? But every time you think about calling an attorney, what do you think about first? That's right. Who do you call? And how much will it cost? Our friends at LegalShield have found a solution. With a nationwide network of 6,900 attorneys who average 19 years of experience, LegalShield's law firms take over 40,000 calls per week helping their members. For less than $20 per month, you can have access to LegalShield on everything from the trivial to the traumatic. Let LegalShield stand up for your rights at lsprotection.com. That's lsprotection.com. Or call 855-340-SAVE, 855-340-7283.
Results will vary from case to case.
Are you suffering with hearing loss? Are you sick of people constantly complaining that your TV is too loud? Are you tired of asking people to speak up? Would you like to hear more clearly, but you don't want to wear a hearing aid that makes you look old? Then you need to try Listen Clear, a life-changing breakthrough precisely designed by top audio engineers to fit your ear almost invisibly. And you can adjust Listen Clear to find the perfect way to hear everything, wherever you are and whatever you're doing. And right now, you can try Listen Clear absolutely risk-free with free shipping. We'll even give you free batteries for life. So call now. 1-800-940-5957. Listen Clear is lightweight and completely hassle-free, and it's practically invisible. Call for your 100% risk-free home trial with free shipping and free batteries for life. For free information, call now. 1-800-940-5957. That's 1-800-940-5957. 1-800-940-5957.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
Free Talk Live. Welcome to the program. We'll, of course, take your calls about anything you would like to discuss. On the way here, if we get the chance, the crackdown on Uber continues, and some terrible news about Uber changing their policy on weapons. Not good at all. We'll get into that if we get the chance. Of course, we'll take your calls first about whatever's on your mind. And we're still talking about police cameras as well, body cameras. And why, according to Virgil Vaduva, who is in studio with us here tonight from truthvoice.com, why people should oppose, five reasons why people should oppose the police body cameras. I think there are reasons to support them. We haven't really gotten into that. I've touched on it here and there, but we're going to continue with your calls here in a moment. 855-450-FREE is our toll-free number. If you're online, you should be the one taking the responsibility for your own protection. You can use different services to protect yourself online, and one of the ones I recommend is ProXPN. It's a global virtual private network. So global, meaning there are servers all around the world that you can connect to with their premium account. You can get a free account over at proxpn.com/FTL. But what they do is they encrypt your data connection. Now, whether it's your cell phone, your laptop, your work computer, computer at home, Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, Linux, pretty much whatever you're running, there's likely a way to connect to ProXPN. There's software that you can download at proxpn.com/FTL. You get connected and you're protected from prying and spying. Your own internet service provider, probably logging the things that you're doing on the internet. Not just your internet service provider, but maybe even criminals who might be trying to sniff out your Wi-Fi packets. Maybe you're sitting at a coffee shop using their Wi-Fi, and maybe the administrator of that Wi-Fi wants to know what you're doing. If you've got ProXPN, nobody knows what you're doing online. In fact, ProXPN doesn't even keep logs of your online habits at all. So go to proxpn.com/FTL. You can get started there for free, but when you're ready to upgrade to premium, you'll get unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world you can connect to, you can privately torrent and get past regionally blocked websites. Plus, ProXPN does not keep records of your online habits, and you get it all with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee at 50% off the regular monthly price when you buy an annual account with our discount code. It's FTL50, FTL like Free Talk Live, and then 50, as in 50% off. Breaks down to about $5 a month. An incredible price on great privacy protection. ProXPN.com/FTL, code FTL50. As we go to your calls and thoughts, we'll start with Luke in South Carolina, listening to WRNN in Myrtle Beach. Hey, Luke.
Hi. I was just calling about the body cams.
Yes,
I'm
sir.
Actually in the police academy.
Mm, okay.
And they teach us that it's up to our discretion to give tickets. Now, if I'm wearing a body cam and I pull someone over and I give them a ticket, but they have 8 other infractions that I could ticket them for, what I'm going to be worried about is if I'm wearing a body cam, is someone in my department going to look at that and say, why didn't you give this guy 8 other tickets?
That's a good concern.
When I really only wanted to give him 1.
That's an interesting point.
If we're all wearing body cams, we're going to be worried about this.
Yeah, here's one thought I have on that. So, for instance, I kind of would like police officers to not have much discretion. I really would like police officers.
Oh, that's a terrible idea.
Yeah, I understand where you come from on this one, but I think that we have way too many laws, and that if people actually bore the full brunt of the government when dealing with police officers, that, well, they might actually get participatory in their local government and roll back the...
They'll just pay the fines.
Or just really, enjoy the abuse.
You think you get 8 tickets and you got a $1,500 fine slapped on you, that people are just going to pay those?
People pay those kind of fines all the time. They get on payment plans. They pay more.
Wow.
So if you can't pay the fine...
That's
pay
poor
the fine,
people. Once you do that to rich people, then you're going to change your mind.
Mm. Well, they don't pick on rich people.
Really?
Oh, I see what you're saying.
Rich people get tickets.
You want them to be like robots that don't have discretion, right?
That's because, what I'm saying.
I mean, that's just a fantasy. That's never going to happen, right? Until you actually do get robot cops, and then we're in a really scary world, aren't we?
This is what he's talking about. Is he talking about if they have cams, then other, you know, the brass, which I believe is the biggest problem with policing in America, is their management of police.
Well, then I guess it depends on the department then, right? Like, that's, you know, if Luke, what you're saying is you're worried that the bosses are going to crack down given the existence of the evidence of more violations that you could have written a ticket for. That speaks more to the people running the department than it does anything else. Like, for instance, here in Keene, New Hampshire, they give warnings regularly. You can look at the police log and you can see every single person that, you know, that gets pulled over by the cops and what the result of that was, as far as did somebody get arrested, you know, was it just a call that, you know, you couldn't find the person that they were telling you to go find or whatever. There's result, and there's frequently warnings in there, so it's pretty clear, at least here in Keene, that these cops could have given a ticket, but in point of fact did not. So I guess it just depends on the department.
So the question is, do they keep track of the warnings they give out? Does someone keep track of them?
It's in
that's
the logs.
Correct.
You can...
that's another point. And it another point comes to it, like, if an 18-year-old has a small bag of marijuana on them, it's up to my discretion to give them a ticket. Now, if it's someone that I could tell is selling drugs, I would give it to them. But if it's someone, some college kid, I wouldn't want to.
Right. So, Luke,
why not give the drug dealer a pass? I mean, look, I got to say, I appreciate, Luke, I appreciate that you would leave.
The people get marijuana from somewhere, Luke.
Right. I appreciate that you. I appreciate that you would let the college kid off. That's cool. But it's probably another college kid who sold him the bag in the first place, you know? I mean, go ahead.
I'm talking about someone who they're out there doing harm, and I've seen them before.
Well, everybody who's got weed got it from somebody who had had bales in a truck.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And ultimately, you know, they're moving weight or they're smoking a joint. There's somebody with weed.
Exactly. And
go ahead.
Yep.
I was just saying, go ahead.
I do have a quick question
for Luke.
Luke. So just quick question. What is the attitude in the police academy towards body cams? Can you just, like, quickly, 30 seconds, give us I'm curious, mostly.
To be honest, they're for them because where I'm at in North Carolina, we're for them because it protects the officer.
Yes, it does.
Okay.
In a number of ways. If in my, where I'm at, they train us to shoot first if a threat is upon us. If
that's
someone has a gun in their hand, well, think about this. If someone has a gun in their hand and they're pacing back and forth, figuring out if they want to start shooting, should I wait for them to shoot off a shot?
Stay
before
away
I shoot
from
him?
Them. That would be a good step forward.
Yeah.
How about asking them to put it down before you know before you shoot?
Well,
I think that's a terrible policy.
That's another thing.
That's what got Tamir Rice, the 12-year-old with the fake gun in Cleveland.
BB gun.
That's what got him shot.
I agree with that. I can see where you're coming with that. But take the case in Florida where the man robbed a Walmart for a rifle and was walking around a town shooting it, and a cop hit him with his car.
Are
they going to get up close and ask him to put it down? That rifle he was shooting can go straight through a car, a police car. And
he was actually shooting this thing.
Right.
I mean, he was shooting at people.
But it's the same thing. If a guy just shot someone and he's pacing back and forth thinking if he wants to shoot someone else.
Okay, if a guy shot somebody, otherwise it could just be somebody who's, you know, dealing with a jam in his gun or something.
We're up here in New Hampshire where it is legal to carry a gun on your hip, and people do.
You can strap a gun to your back legally in New Hampshire, too. Luke, thanks for your call tonight. I appreciate the perspective from inside the business of policing, if you want to call it that, which I really generally don't. But thanks for the call. 855-450-FREE. And you can share your thoughts here on the live Saturday edition of Free Talk Live on police body cameras or the cops in general or anything.
If you owe $10,000 or more to the IRS or state in back taxes, you know they'll never stop coming after you. With bank levies, wage garnishments, they'll even seize your home or business. The good news? A government program for tax debt forgiveness. It's called the Fresh Start Initiative.
I'm Paul Sibley with U.S. Tax Shield. We can help navigate the new laws, get you protected, and resolve your tax issues permanently.
Call the experts at U.S. Tax Shield now for your free consultation and get a guaranteed quote to resolve your case. Call 800-436-6451. That's 800-436-6451.
Now a twice as nice twin kit special offer from Complete H2O Minerals for all GCN listeners. Get a Complete H2O Minerals twin kit with 33 different minerals, vitamins, and amino acids all in a liquid form. Enough for two people for 1 month. Regular price $89.95, but now Complete H2O Minerals is offering the twin kit for $69.95. And all GCN listeners receive a bonus 16-ounce bottle of ionic silver absolutely free with free shipping. A $120 total value. Hurry, limited time offer. Call 803-794-4767 or click CompleteH2OMinerals.com.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting bloc and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. FreeStateProject.org. Sign up now at FreeStateProject.org.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used, and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com. On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live here. On the live Saturday edition, the Porkfest Eve edition of the program, the week-long camping festival put on by the Free State Project yearly here in New Hampshire, in the beautiful northern White Mountains of New Hampshire, will be kicking off tomorrow and going all the way through the following Sunday. So the 21st through the 28th, we will be there. Virgil's going to be there. Free Talk Live broadcasting live. lots of other great shows from LRN.FM are going to be broadcasting their programs live, and so many different activities, so many things to do for families, for singles, for couples, whatever. If you love liberty, that's the only qualification to come to the Porcupine Freedom Festival. You'll find over 1,500 people likely who are like you at this festival. And it's a wonderful group of folks. And
it's life-changing.
It absolutely is. And something else that could be a change in your life, Fort Galt.
Yeah, what Fort Galt is a community that they're building down in South America, in Chile. And it's for people who want to get out of the United States or have perhaps a bug-out location, or people who, you know, world travelers, entrepreneurs, freelancers, young professionals, small business owners, and their families. You buy in by getting a small condominium. It's just a sleeping room and maybe a desk. They have different sizes. Their smallest unit's $10,000. And you don't need the money all up front by any stretch of the imagination. They only have you pay in as they reach certain benchmarks. And you get this unit. Now, there's lots of communal spaces inside this, and that's really where the collaboration goes on. The idea is to create a community as much as, a building. And I think you should check it out, because their video is well worth seeing. They have a very well done high-end video and a great website. It's very well done. FortGalt.com. FortGalt. So as in John Galt. FortGalt.com.
All right, let's continue here. You can share your thoughts, bring up anything that you would like to discuss. Let's go to, and we've been talking about police body cameras, for instance. Jason is in Virginia listening to WNIS. Hello, Jason.
Hey, thanks for having me.
Welcome, sir. Go ahead.
I love the show. You guys kind of confuse me sometimes, though. You guys are advocates for ordinary citizens for their encounters with police officers, correct?
Yeah, absolutely. I'm a huge fan of what they do over at copblock.org, which is encouraging average folks I don't know if it was launched on the show, but...
This was the first big promotion the cop block had.
We were around helping promote them back in the day. But yeah, holding people accountable, holding the police accountable by recording video. So yeah, I would say all three of the hosts on this show support that.
Absolutely.
I mean, I can't speak for everybody. Mark, you agree?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. So yeah, go ahead, Jason.
Okay, yeah, and forgive me if I go over something you've already been through. I tuned in at the end of the list.
No problem, go ahead.
It would seem to me that, police officers wearing those cameras would say, I'm on camera, I better not do that. It would hold both sides accountable, where, you may have a citizen accuse the officer of rape, and would, that would alleviate that accusation. For both sides.
Yep.
And also maybe the money they spend on that is the less money that they're out spending on MRAP.
They get the MRAPs for free, but the Homeland Security gives them the Bearcat.
Grants.
They will always find the money if they need it.
But I think Jason's making some good points, and I'd like to clarify that earlier we were reading, Virgil, your article about five reasons to oppose police cameras, but I think there are reasons to support them as well. Like a lot of technology, this is a double-sided sword, and there are reasons on both sides of this. There's not one, right or wrong position here, I don't think. And I think that it can protect average folks, and it can protect the police. And look, the police, not all of them are monsters, right? Like, they're people who are in
roles. By no means.
They're people who are in roles that we disagree with, that are doing things that we might not always agree with,
right,
as far as what they're doing. But in a lot of cases, they deal with some scummy people, right? And some of those scummy people are going to tell lies about those cops and what those cops allegedly did to them. But if there's video, then
right,
that might actually save money on lawsuits. I mean, you want to talk about saving money if this amount that they've spent on these video cameras prevents multiple suits from being filed against the department. That could, in the long run, save taxpayers' dollars.
Would it not be easier, though, to push the responsibility of recording the cops onto citizens and teach them how to record? That way we take the camera away from the cop. We take the ownership of the video away from the government.
It's by no means a labor-saving device, though,
it
right?
Is not.
Like sending out citizens on the streets to watch their government bureaucrats.
No.
Jason, any other thoughts you want to share tonight? Go ahead.
I you can't always count on another citizen to be there or
very true.
A third party to take care of that for you. I also had a question about, you guys advocate for completely open borders. I can't understand that either, because the reality is that there are people in the world that wish us harm. And
yeah, a lot of them are in Washington, D.C. They're already here.
That's true. But I would like to know who comes in and out of my house.
No, this isn't your house, and you don't have a right to know who comes in and out of my house, do you?
Well, no, but America is my house.
That's a silly thing to say. I mean, it's a plot of land. It's an arbitrary plot of land defined by, you know, men who are long since dead. And I'm sorry, I don't trust the police state to keep me safe from the evil folks who are out around the world who want to do harm to me. It's the people here in the United States calling themselves the government that I have the biggest concern of. They're the ones who are regularly threatening me. They're the ones who are threatening peaceful people and who are arresting peaceful people. And they're already here. What do we do about them?
That's an issue in and of itself.
Yeah, you want those people to run your borders, because they're the ones who are running the borders. Right, those people who are going to threaten and hurt peaceful people are the ones running the borders, supposedly protecting you. It's all a farce. It's security theater.
When you turn over the immigration to the government, the first thing you have to say is that the government's doing a good job running immigration with the amount of people it's bringing in. And I think that the first thing we can say about the government is it doesn't do a good job of anything. So we don't know the right amount of people to come into this country. We know that that people coming into this country are good for the economy. They spend money. They buy things. They may send some money home. There's no doubt about it. But who's to stop me from sending money outside the country, too? You send money outside the country every time you buy something from Walmart.
Right, right. And that, as the only immigrant in the show, I believe, right? You guys have not immigrated. Yeah, I think I've experienced this firsthand. It's a terrible experience. The government is terrible in managing the immigration process. And honestly, the statement that America is my home is ludicrous on its face, because I'm pretty sure that it was the home of someone else before we got here. So I think that's a little bit, you know, confusing to a lot of folks to hear that.
Right, but I currently live here at this moment in Virginia, in the United States of America. So would that not be a larger representation of my home? And I'm not advocating for more government regulation or anything like that. That's the farthest thing.
You are if you're advocating for the government getting into immigration, because the only way they can control immigration, because at this point they can't handle the borders. So they've got to do, they do random checks, but they're already doing that within 100 miles of the border. So you're advocating for random checks of citizens who are just going about their days. And then after that, they're already going into businesses, demanding paperwork from small businesses, adding a huge amount of work on small businesses that don't need that extra work, just to be able to find out, how many of the evil Mexicans are you hiding in here? And, the only thing left is knocking on your door and going through your closets, dude, looking for Mexicans.
I think you misunderstood me. I'm not advocating for random checkpoints.
But you've got them. Wait. You have random checkpoints. But you have random checkpoints.
I disagree with that completely. I believe that's
so. You want to somehow restrict immigration? Hold on. How can you want to restrict immigration and at the same time believe that you're not going to have greater government?
I'm saying that I think that it's too hard for people that wish to go through the process legally to get in. However, I do believe that there has to be some sort of vetting process where you don't allow, known terrorists.
But the only way to find out if people who aren't vetted are in the United States is to have a total police state. And I see on one side you're saying you don't support that, and thank you for that.
They can't stop dishwashers from coming across the border. How are they going to stop terrorists?
Jason, good call. Appreciate hearing from you tonight here. There's a lot to learn on this issue, and I'd recommend some online resources. Libertarian. Just going to search for borders, open borders. And
Openborders.org will tell you how to double the world GDP in 1 year.
Nice. All right, 855-450-FREE.
It is the year 91,001 BCE. Witness humanity's origins in Hypercronius, a classic role-playing game for Windows PCs with a story like no other game before. The liberty-oriented experience that is not to be missed. Go to zog.ninja to get your copy of Hypercronius today. Use the code FTL to get $1 off. Hypercronius, zog.ninja, code FTL.
Geico Motorcycle presents Reflections from the Road.
The day I knew I was a real biker was when I switched to Geico Motorcycle Insurance. Because real bikers, well, they know where the savings are. And you know what else makes you a real biker? A sweet tattoo. Check mine out. Just got it yesterday. It says Heal on Wheels. Wait, Heal on Wheels? Oh, man. Well, at least I got the saving money with Geico part, right?
Geico Motorcycle Insurance. See how much you could save.
Virtually anyone can hack your cell phone and track your calls, your texts, your emails, your every movement, but only if they can detect a signal. Stay one step ahead of hackers and Big Brother with a Blockit Pocket, a custom-made pocket infused with pure silver that creates a complete Faraday enclosure for your cell phone. For free shipping to the Lower 48, visit blockitpocket.com or call 888-315-9618, blockitpocket.com, enhancing health and privacy.
Did you know some countries are now banning GMO foods? It's true. That's why for quality storable foods, you need ready-made resources. For over 19 years, we've become the name you can trust for thousands of products, like Numana Healthy Food Storage. All Numana storable foods are non-GMO, non-soy and gluten-free available. Call 800-627-3809 or click readymaderesources.com. Ready-made resources. We don't just sell the products, we live it.
Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year's keynote speeches and panels will be announced via the Keenvention blog and Facebook, so stay tuned there for the latest. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 30th through November 1st. Tickets are available now at a special early bird price of just $50 via credit card or Bitcoin. That $50 price only lasts through the end of June, so don't delay. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more and look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love, but make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Boost Kit Essentials Nutritionally Complete Drink, providing your picky eater with essential nutrition and great taste in one drink. Visit us at kitessentials.com. To make sure your kids eat healthy, follow the 5-a-day plan. Serve 3 servings of vegetables and 2 servings of fruit daily. Remember, a serving could just mean a piece of fruit or a half cup of veggies. If your kids are picky eaters, ask a nutritionist about other sources. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live on this live Saturday edition here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And if you support the show here on Free Talk Live, one of the things you can do to support us more directly is to shop with us at shop.freetalklive.com. Links are there to Amazon, and you can enter those Amazon links to Amazon UK, Amazon Canada, and Amazon US, and then get your shopping done. Free Talk Live gets a cut of the sale. Very simple. Same great prices you're used to. So just go and start your shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
If we're going to go into this immigration thing, which was sort of what was brought up in the last segment, I intend to go on
with some phone calls here, but what do you want to say?
I just want a couple of caveats thrown out because our position often gets misinterpreted because we take the calls before we talk about things in so many cases.
Uh-huh.
Right. Nobody wants immigration in a country where you've got to pay for people coming in, right? Like nobody wants to say, hey, let's bring in more welfare recipients.
Yeah.
There's nobody's going to be for that sort of immigration. I'm not. But let's remember, this isn't a fault of the immigrants. This is a fault of the welfare system. Mm-hmm. If you put a bowl of milk out every morning outside of your doorstep, do not get angry if stray cats come by and drink the milk. You're putting the milk out. It's your fault for putting the milk out, not the cat's fault for eating it. And so this is really important. Obviously, America's adventurism around the world is a big issue too. So I don't think that people should be responsible for paying for the welfare of immigrants that come here. And I don't think the United States should be creating terrorists around the world that want to come in and kill us.
All right, let's go to your calls and thoughts. So we've been mostly talking about police cameras tonight, the body cams, and whether or not they are a good idea. And there's some real reasons that people should oppose them, but I think there's also some reasons to support them. We'll dig into it further here, but you can also bring up anything you want. Greg is in Indianapolis listening to WIBC-FM. Hello, Greg.
Gentlemen, how are you?
Great. Go ahead with your thoughts tonight.
Well, I wanted to bring up the point that you had earlier about a no big contract.
Yeah, this was an example that Virgil had given. He wrote the article about the police cameras over at truthvoice.com about the taser company being given a no-bid agreement, at least one that
just
you know
one.
Of.
There's probably a bunch of them. Yeah.
But yeah, by police department. Go ahead.
Right. And I'm not trying to be antagonistic with this question. Have you, either of you, sourced or contracted goods or services from either the private or public sector?
Yeah.
Okay. I currently work for an organization where I'm responsible for reviewing contracts on a regular basis. So the answer is yes.
Okay.
I'm not a government employee though. So.
No. I'm just saying. Like I said, I'm not trying to be antagonistic. I'm just trying to get your view on this subject. There are times when you want gadget Y. As a department head, and you have a budget, it's regardless of the source of the money, you just have a budget.
Sure. But you wouldn't call that the free market, though, would you?
But wait a minute. Regardless of the source of the money, in this case, we're talking about taxpayer dollars.
Right. Regardless of the source,
shouldn't you be concerned with being under that budget and being as far under that budget as you possibly can, yet getting a good product for the dollar? Shouldn't you be concerned with the value for what you're getting?
Absolutely. Either side of that equation, whether it's tax money, obviously you have, I believe, a more onerous approach to that money. But whether it's tax money or investor money, you have a budget. You cannot, as a department head, increase your budget. Here it is. Here's your budget.
But the budget has nothing to do with this, though. This is all about the idea of giving someone the opportunity to enter into a contract with you and giving them money, basically, without any bid or without any competition.
Yeah, my frustration with the gentleman who called in was he used terms like no coercion, which, of course, tax money is always gotten with coercion, and he used the term free market, and in the sort of the same breath as no-bid contracts. And these are, these things shouldn't be used this way. Certainly, a department head. Go ahead, sir.
No, you're absolutely right. We're colluding way too many terms. When a department head, whether government or private, goes out to spend their budget, they have certain requirements. And you know what? When I need gadget Y, I need gadget Y. I don't need... It is not my objective as a department head to go out and create innovation.
I'm sorry, I'm just to interrupt you here. We're not talking about you innovating. We're talking about you as a department head opening up a bid process as a government entity, which is what the police department is, and opening up a process where more than one company can come in, present their product, present their offer for what it would take to outfit the department with the police cameras. Doesn't that seem like the fiscally prudent thing to do?
No. Yeah, and here's why.
Please go through an assessment process. You make sure you choose the right device and the best device for your team.
Apparently not. He's
going
to explain why not.
Okay.
Go ahead.
No. Sometimes, and not always, it's very easy to research the marketplace for what you need. And, man, this gadget is it. It's the only one.
You're presuming, right? You're presuming that the police chief did all this research and found out that this was the best option in the market, and he is so absolutely sure of it that he is not even willing to listen to anyone else, right? That's what you're arguing for?
No.
Because that's what we're talking about. When it's a no-bid contract, you're not listening to any other offers. You've just made a deal with Taser International because somebody scratched your back with a free vacation or something like that, and you know, you cut this million-dollar deal. Where's your evidence?
CBS News.
Right. These guys are currently, a lot of these former police chiefs who have written and signed contracts with Taser, they are currently working for Taser International. That's their payback. It's a scheme. It may not necessarily be illegal, but it's highly unethical from what I can see. Do you not believe this is unethical?
No, I agree that's highly unethical. But I'm not willing to use the wide paintbrush to say all no bid contracts. We call them zero price contracts. It just depends on which side of the pendulum you're on, whether you're on the government side or the private side. They all do it, and it's for a reason.
Just because they do. Yeah, the reason is you enrich your good old boy buddies. That's what the reason is. It's the good old boy network from top to bottom. And thank you for the call tonight, Greg. You can deny it all you want. You can deny it all you want. There's a good old boy network out there, and every government has it, whether it's a big government like New York City or a little government like Keene, New Hampshire. There are certain people in industry who get contracts. They're more likely to get contracts, or they get no-bid contracts, which means they can pump up their prices as much as they possibly can within the budget, and then get.
It seems like government contracts are always more expensive than private market ones, and you wonder when they're buying 420 cameras for $1.4 million where all that money is going, right? When like Virgil said, a GoPro camera is significantly less costly.
I am amazed that we've now had two people call in tonight to defend the practice of not listening to even a single other offer and having no-bid contracts within government.
Okay,
amazing.
So I'm
going to
defend it, and I'm going to do a better job. My fire chief buys Minotaur radios, okay?
Okay, these two-way radio?
No, well, they're not always two-way.
Okay.
Some of them are just one-way
alert
radios. Yeah, they look like little pagers, and then the officers get the big radios. Now, if he's going to get, say, he's going to get another five radios or whatever at, and for this, for us, that's a big deal. We, you know, got 20 something people, you know, in the fire department. So he has to get five radios or something like that. He's not going to bid that contract because they have to be Minotaurs.
Well, duh, you already have that system.
Right.
We're talking about when the original system was bought was when you need to put it out to bid, right?
Sure. And that's when you should be finding out which radios are going to work for you and that sort of thing. But, you know, in that case, that's a no-bid contract.
Yeah, but it's not the same situation. That's just you're reordering parts in that case for an existing contract, not even the same jurisdiction at all. So if you want to call and defend the practice of no bid contracts, giving contracts out to your buddies in government when you're in the government, rewarding your friends who are in the industry, whether it's the people who construct the roads, whether it's the people who are making these.
Isn't this
cameras?
How the mob got started with no bid contracts on trash pickups? In at least that's what the rumor is.
Well, that's what we're talking about here, isn't it? I mean, the government is the mob. That's basically what they do. I understand they provide some valuable services like clearing the roads and, you know, fixing them every now and then. And, you know, there's a fire service. I'm not saying that everything they do is a bad thing, but it's just a basic part of trying to look legitimate. They have to try to look legitimate. Otherwise, they'll lose their aura of legitimacy. And if people don't see governments as legitimate, then they'll start to see them as criminal gangs, which is what they, in point of fact, are.
Right.
And so the more they do things like no-bid contracts, the more it looks bad for them. So, I mean, to some extent, we should support the no-bid contracts because it makes them look bad. But obviously, we can't do that because that would be, you know, dishonest with ourselves. 855-450-FREE.
I'm Steve Sitkowski, a former Wall Street insider. I'm holding a book that will show you investing strategies which could help you earn the kind of money you've always dreamed about. And right now, I'm giving this book away for free. So who needs to read it? If you're in the middle of your career and worry you'll never have enough money to retire, you need to read this book. If you're already retired and your income isn't enough, you need to read this book. And if you don't want to be selling burgers at 80, you need to read this free book. It includes the strategy I use to make a 72% profit on a trade where the stock only moved 12%. You'll need at least $1 million to ever fully retire. If you're behind on that goal, you really need to read Trade Like the Pros. And you can for free by calling 1-800-944-5836. Skeptical that it will deliver results? It's a free book, so what do you have to lose? Find out how at 1-800-944-5836. 1-800-944-5836.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, June 20th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.10 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,200 per ounce, and according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $244. Antiwar.com reports the Yemen peace talks being held in Geneva effectively ended yesterday with the announcement that the pro-Saudi Hadi faction will withdraw from the talks and return to exile in Saudi Arabia, which is presently attacking Yemen with the goal of reinstalling them as the government. The talks began inauspiciously Monday with the demands from the Hadi faction that the Houthis surrender all cities in the country as a condition for discussing an end to the Saudi strikes. Yemeni Foreign Minister Riyad Yassin complained that the Houthis did not comply with any of their demands. It is unsurprising that the talks are collapsing at this point, as a press conference on Thursday by the Houthis ended in fistfights when the Hadi faction attacked them, throwing shoes at the delegate addressing the assembled media. The Saudis never really stopped their airstrikes during the talk and continued with the talks yesterday after the lack of resolution. UN officials expressed disappointment in the process, noting the Hadi and Houthi factions never even sat down at the same table during the 5 days and insisted the UN transfer messages back and forth. The only time they were even in the same room was during Thursday's brawl.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports the former CEO of a company that sells and operates red light cameras told a judge she bribed officials in Cincinnati and Columbus, Ohio to secure and maintain contracts with the cities. Karen Finley of Cave Creek, Arizona pled guilty Friday in U.S. District Court in the Southern District of Ohio to conspiracy to commit federal programs bribery and honest services wire and mail fraud. Between 2005 and 2013, Finley was CEO of Redflex Traffic Systems, a company that sets up cameras at intersections to snap photos of vehicles running red lights. She admitted she participated in a scheme in which the company made campaign contributions to elected officials in the two cities in exchange for securing red light camera contracts with the municipalities. Additionally, the company concealed the contributions through invoices labeling the payments as being for consulting services to a third party who then made the contributions. Columbus City Council member and current mayoral candidate Andrew Ginther is one of those officials alleged to have received a campaign contribution contribution from Red Flex Traffic Systems. Ginther released a statement Friday denying the claims. He said, "I had absolutely no knowledge of these activities and did not take part in them. While I am not subject of the inquiry, I have been asked to provide records that may help the investigation into Red Flex. I've fully cooperated and will continue to assist in bringing these people to justice. In light of these charges, I have asked City Attorney Rick Pfeiffer to conduct an investigation into any current contracts between the city and Red Flex." The U.S. Department of Justice said that Finley will be sentenced at a future date. You can support FPP Radio by joining the Fans program. Fans are friends, allies, and numerous supporters. Fans help FPP afford to produce more original content. You can join the Fans program for as little as $3 per month or any amount of Bitcoin per month, thanks to the recurring payment options provided by Coinbase. To learn more or to join the Fans program, visit fans.fppradio.com. That's fans.fppradio.com. Reuters reports a state board revoked the license of a former U.S. Army doctor on Friday, finding that he plied students with hypnotic drugs during battlefield trauma training and performed dangerous procedures, including intentionally inducing shock. The doctor, John Henry Hagman, was cited for training he provided in 2012 and 2013 in Virginia, North Carolina, Colorado, and Great Britain. Students testified on Friday that Hagman also performed penile nerve blocks and instructed them to insert catheters into one another's genitals. Assistant Attorney General Frank Pedrotti told the Virginia Board of Medicine, "The evidence is so overwhelming and so bizarre as to almost shock the conscience of a prosecutor who's been doing this for 26 years. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Officials at PepsiCo announced today the upcoming launch of Mountain Dew Cineblast after the company's market research team unknowingly fell victim to a malicious focus group that convinced them cinnamon-flavored Mountain Dew was the next big thing.
We were the people in the focus group. They couldn't get enough of it. And then they said, the more cinnamon, the better. So we are going to put in more cinnamon. We are really excited for people to try this product.
According to PepsiCo's data, all gathered from a single group of ill-intentioned respondents, customers of all ages will love the new soft drink's murky brownish-green color and will soon be lining up to try the carbonated beverage jam-packed with ground cinnamon. Various members of the focus group told reporters they believed the company had made a great decision.
Cineblast is the best. I mean, I can't wait to tell all of my friends to go buy this thing.
Yeah. The only way they can make it better is if they took a couple of raw eggs, mixed them up in the bottle. People would go nuts.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live, welcome back to the program. Here we're launching into the third hour. There's plenty of time for you to share your thoughts with us here tonight. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've been talking a lot about police body cameras, and Virgil Vaduva has written a list of five reasons why he says people should oppose these police body cameras. And I think there are reasons to support them as well, although I agree with his reasons to oppose them. They're pretty good ones, like the fact that these things could be used as some sort of arms for some centralized spy network from the government, scanning the faces of everybody who walks by a cop.
Not sci-fi.
No, absolutely not. That's technically possible right now. And there are some other great points. You can share your thoughts with us here. 855-450-FREE. It's Ian, Virgil, and Mark in the studio tonight as we go to your calls and thoughts. Let's start with Josh, listening in Florida. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Josh.
Hey, how's it going?
Welcome, sir. You are the air.
Awesome. I think that body cameras on police are a really good idea, but with a few stipulations, because everybody's so worried about privacy invading and all that stuff, and, you know, being used for the wrong purposes. I think it should be mandatory for all police officers to wear a recording device on their lapel, not one they can turn off or on at any time, that one that records the whole time they're working. But also at the same time, nobody should be able to view that footage, period. When they get back to the station, it should be automatically downloaded into a hard drive that nobody can view, archived under a number, and the only way that it can actually be viewed is with a court order. That way nobody's privacy is invaded. Right, sir.
I guess I see where you're coming from there.
He who holds the hard drive holds the power.
I can see where you're coming from there with a privacy concern, but on the other hand, I would more favor the more open approach where everyone can view the video.
Yeah, doesn't that footage belong to us, the people?
Yes, it does, but there would be a big problem with that, like all these issues with the camera, the recording thing with the... trying to remember when they were like hands up, don't shoot, all the big things that were happening, and people saw footage and they had already gotten in their mind a verdict for what happened with that, and then it would go through courts and trials over months, and you know, come to find out that they did what they were supposed to, and then people get mad and they flip out and because they don't like the verdict. So I don't think people should be able to view something like that that is being used in a court trial until the court trial is over. And yeah, then it should be made open to public. That way there could be no, like, misconstruments or, you know, with the media and everything blowing stuff out of proportion. The only people who really need to see that evidence are the people in the courtroom making that decision, the judge.
Yeah, but
jury.
I want to know what the cops are doing. I want to know what they're up to. They're spending my money that they've taken by the threat of force, and I should have the right to know what they're doing. I mean, if any time I want to, I can file and receive a report from any situation.
Yeah,
you know,
public
where the
records request.
Right, where the police write up a report, which includes usually name and address information of the people who are involved.
A bigger problem would be seeing your girlfriend with another guy hanging out in the public somewhere. I don't
know. Josh, thanks for your call tonight. I appreciate it. Toll-free number here, 855-450-FREE. Let's go to Corey, who is on the line in South Carolina via Skype. Go ahead, Corey.
Hey, first, real quick, before I get into what I really called about, that's some really expensive cameras when you consider that they're probably going to have the highest failure rate of any camera on Earth.
Oh, yeah.
The police cams.
These cameras
are designed that way.
All the time.
They're designed on purpose that way. Yes.
Exactly. So what I really called about was a couple of nights ago, someone had called in with a scenario in a situation where there was a stateless society. If I kill someone and I claim it's in self-defense and, you know, they're basically, in essence, their insurance company or their security service claims that it was not in self-defense, then what do you do? And I think it's important as an individual who supports the concept of a stateless or voluntary society that we be able to address issues like this. And I think it was one of you guys on your show that originally said, unless you believe in a one-world government, you already are a voluntarist.
I don't remember that being said, but you know, that's an interesting thing to say.
I say brilliant things all the time.
was there a comment you wanted to make about that?
Yeah. So the way that would be dealt with is the same way it's dealt with if I shoot someone, claim it's in self-defense, and then I flee to Mexico. That's a geographical boundary, and there wouldn't be these geographical boundaries in a stateless society. But in essence, these insurance companies or these arbitration services would have what amounts to extradition treaties. There would not be one in existence that would want to allow someone to get away with murder. And there would be, you know, that would be one way that it would be dealt with.
And further, the two companies that might be involved, you know, again, they're in a dispute. One company saying our client's innocent. The other company saying he did it. There would be other agreements as well between the companies that they would have an arbitrator between them, right? So they, you know, if there's a dispute, they would then go to arbitration and it would all get hammered out.
In the ancient world, they had these things called the cities of refuge where, you know, if you did something wrong, you could actually go seek refuge in that city and you would not be kicked out unless you did, again, something wrong. So it would be interesting to take that concept and apply it to the modern world and see how that works out. Of course, there are always bounties that you can place on people, right? In a stateless society,
that's true.
You can send people after them to hunt them down if they wronged you. There are all kinds of ways to.
But you better be able to prove they wronged
you. Absolutely.
Because if you kidnap somebody who you say committed some sort of crime, but you don't really have any evidence of that,
that
would be kidnapping.
Yep.
And, you know, if you can't prove that they actually did what you say that they did. Whereas today, when the police take somebody who didn't do it, and then they lock them away or whatever. There's no, almost no accountability for the officers who made those choices.
Or the prosecutor, who I think is, you know, like, I don't generally think it's the police on the street. I generally think it's the higher ups. And the prosecutors face nothing. There was a prosecutor, I believe the first prosecutor in the history of the United States to be jailed for a bad prosecution, got 10 days for a dude he sent to prison for 25 years. Nice. I want to repeat those numbers for you. 10 days for sending a man, an innocent man, to prison for 25 years.
That'll show him.
There is no punishment for doing something wrong as a prosecutor.
Let's go to Scott, listening in Indianapolis to WIBC-FM. Hello, Scott. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Virgil, and Mark.
Yes, I want to make a comment. I just tuned in about the analogy you made about the border, and your example was you can't blame the cats coming to your back porch because you keep putting a bowl of milk out there. And my answer to that is, well, of course I want to feed my cat and not the neighborhood cat. So what I do is I put a fence up to keep the other neighborhood cats out. Thus, now we can expand it to the border. Because you yourself said, well, you don't want all the people come here just to get the welfare. How do you suggest you segregate the ones that are coming across that just want the welfare without putting up a fence and screening them as they come in?
I have two solutions for you, neither of which you're going to like because you don't want people coming across the border, but I'll give them to you anyway. Solution number one, you give anybody who wants to cross the border a green card, and that green card does not allow them to get any kind of welfare benefits. So nobody who comes to this country who isn't a citizen gets welfare benefits, period. That's solution number one, and I believe the more feasible in our political climate. Solution number two, you get rid of welfare entirely. Really, all it does is enable people who are going to scam the system and make people who would otherwise work not work. I understand lots of people don't like the idea of welfare. I believe that charity can fill in the slots that welfare, doesn't.
Yeah, and honestly, just a quick note, I don't believe most people want to immigrate to the United States to get welfare. It's very difficult to get welfare.
Some do,
as an immigrant.
Not the immigrants
Some
I've ever known.
Yeah,
they've been hard-working
Most immigrants
folks.
Want to come here to work, make money, send money to their families, and support their communities and support their families. That's
ahead,
the truth.
Go ahead, Scott.
Hey, I'm a second-generation immigrant myself. My
right.
grandparents came from Germany. So I have no problem with immigration. Like the gentleman before me said, you know, it should be legal. Why do people get a cut in line? The problem with what you just said about getting rid of welfare and all that, there's a whole political part.
We're losing you there, Scott. Thanks for the call tonight. There is a system around welfare, I think is what he's saying. It's impossible to get rid of welfare.
It's impossible to get rid of it. It's impossible to secure the border.
Yeah.
That's the whole point. You think that somehow the government, you can't use to get rid of welfare, you're going to use to stop immigration.
The fence exactly. is not tall enough.
It's because the government can only grow. It cannot shrink. That's what you're advocating for. More states.
855-450-FREE. Join us.
Attention, business owners. Do you know the three most critical letters in business?
CEO?
MBA?
Nope. Here's a hint. These three little letters can make the difference between making a fortune and losing everything.
ROI?
The answer is INC, as in incorporation. Because if you're not incorporated and someone sues your business, you can lose it all. Your home, your car, even your life savings. That's why Incorporate.com is now giving away a free incorporation guide to all business owners. So you can incorporate in just 10 minutes. Protect your home. Protect your car. Protect your life savings. Call 1-800-941-1029 for your free 10-minute incorporation guide from Incorporate.com. They don't provide legal or financial advice. They just make incorporating or forming an LLC quick and easy. Get the three little letters that can mean the difference between making a fortune and losing everything. For your free guide, call 1-800-941-1029. That's 1-800-941-1029.
Hi, John Huebner from Midas Resources. Are you tired of watching your hard-earned assets dwindle away? As government spending is out of hand and the Federal Reserve is creating in excess of $20 billion a week, are you tired of stockbrokers gambling away your hard-earned money? Is this market a setup for a crash greater than 1987? Too many of today's policies resemble those that led to the collapse of 1929.
This is John Huebner, and that was me in 2007.
And we all know what happened when the subprime credit bubble burst. By March 2009, the dollar lost 50% of its value. The entire U.S. banking system was on the verge of collapsing. Like all financial problems of the past, is history about to repeat itself? Call me, John Huebner, at 1-800-686-2237, extension 129, before it's too late to protect yourself. Will the oncoming catastrophe take all private IRAs, 401ks with it? There is a way to protect your hard-earned assets. Call me, John Huebner, at 1-800-686-2237, extension 129.
Cato University is the Cato Institute's premier educational event of the year. It's being held this year from July the 26th to the 31st at the Cato Institute's state-of-the-art headquarters in Washington, D.C. This annual program brings together outstanding faculty and participants from across the country and often from around the globe, with everyone sharing a commitment to liberty and learning. Cato University is a genuine community, and you can freely share viewpoints, concerns, ideas, questions, and more in an atmosphere of friendship and personal respect. It's a one-of-a-kind program for people who don't stop thinking after they got out of school. It's for people who don't want politicians or bureaucrats or officials to do their thinking for them. It's for people who value liberty. You'll learn, you'll be inspired, you'll make new friends, you'll meet great people from around the world. All of the details are spelled out at the Cato website, cato.org, and they hope to see you there this summer, July the 26th through the 31st in Washington, D.C. Again, details are at cato.org.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the free state, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime, 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
Free Talk Live, you can dial in and join us here on the live Saturday edition. It's the Porkfest Eve edition of Free Talk Live. Porkfest kicks off tomorrow at the Rogers Campground in Lancaster, New Hampshire, the beautiful White Mountains. It's been a year since we've been there, and I always enjoy the event, but also the view. I'm really looking forward to seeing the White Mountains again. It's so pretty up there in Lancaster at the Rogers Campground, where for an entire week, Rogers will be transformed into the Agora, the open marketplace where all kinds of interesting things are being sold openly, and it is just a lot of fun to be there with hundreds, in fact, over probably 1,500 liberty-minded folks, anarchists, voluntarists, even some minarchists sprinkled in there as well. So, Virgil, you're heading up tomorrow.
Mark,
you're heading up tomorrow.
Yep.
I'm heading up there. There's going to be a carpool actually coming up from the Keene area, and people are coming from all around the country, some showing up tomorrow and staying for the whole week, others just, you know, coming when they can get there, maybe Friday, maybe Thursday. The sooner you can get to Porkfest, you know, the better. It's a great event. Don't miss it. Porkfest.com, P-O-R-C-F-E-S-T.com. And I think at this point, you're probably going to have to buy your tickets there. You cannot order online anymore. At least that's what Cecilyn told us on Friday night.
I don't think it's sold out, but you cannot buy them online.
Correct. So you have to show up physically in person, and there's room for you. This is a huge campground, and there are probably still some RV spots that are available, which you don't have to have an RV for. You can pop a few tents.
Someone will cuddle with you if you show up.
There's actually going to be a cuddle party, Virgil. I don't know if you're aware of that.
I was. That's why I said that.
Yeah, so there's all kinds of interesting things happening at the Porcupine Freedom Festival. Let's go to your calls and thoughts, however. First, Mark, I want you to tell me about the Peacekeeper.
Can you do it? Actually, you're familiar with this product more than I am.
I am, actually. Well, the Peacekeeper is it's a program that was released for Android, and I think there's one for iPhone as well. I've got the Android phone, so I don't really pay attention to iPhone. And what it does is it sort of creates a network of folks who want to respond, be first responders in an incident, maybe a fire or an abduction or some sort of health emergency.
Or have people in their neighborhood respond for them. Yeah.
Yeah. But the problem with the first app was that it had some bugs. And there were some features, some big features that just weren't there that really needed to be there. And so they need to do Peacekeeper 2.0, and they're looking to put together a fundraiser. It's already started over on Indiegogo to help raise some money to develop Peacekeeper 2.0, which will have some really cool new features, like a verified network of peacekeepers you can call in an emergency, and you'll not have to rely on just the people you know. Every peacekeeper who's in the area, whether you know them or not, is a potential ally. Or at least will be in this new version of the software. They're looking to raise some money, and you can go and help them out by going to pk.freetalklive.com. That's PK like Peacekeeper, pk.freetalklive.com. Peacekeeper is more than an app. It's a movement. It's a revolutionary system designed to challenge the status quo, and it's a tool that will allow ordinary people to stand up and be heroes. It's a fast, flexible alert system that can keep you safe better than dialing 911. And again, it exists now, but in sort of a rudimentary form. Then you really need to take it to the next level, and they need your help. So you can contribute to their campaign and get some perks over at pk.freetalklive.com. As we go to your calls and thoughts, we've got Mike in Iowa. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Mike. Mike in Iowa going once. Mike in Iowa going twice. Maybe there are some technical difficulties. We'll put Mike on hold, and instead we will try Straight Razor, listening via TuneIn in Texas. Straight Razor, are you with us?
Good evening, gentlemen. How are you?
Hey, I'm well. You are a former police officer. You've been an officer in Texas with multiple departments, and you've called the show on a number of occasions to express some real friendliness towards the ideas of liberty. And in fact, that has gotten you fired from multiple police departments, apparently. So I know you were calling in about maybe something else, but did you hear the conversation we were having earlier about the police body cameras?
Yes, that's actually what I'm calling about.
Oh, okay.
And I kind of fall closer to your side of I would like to be able to review any officer in the area at any time. Mm-hmm. But on the other side of that, whenever you're in your home or on your property, you have a presumption of privacy.
Right.
And you're supposed to have that privacy. So whenever, even if you haven't called the police, someone else has called, and all mm-hmm. of a sudden you've got six police officers with cameras rolling on your property, that's when things start to get kind of complicated for me.
Very
as far
true.
As being able to review. And then you throw on top of that, maybe you have children who are minors. So now all of your business will be out there.
If you answer the door for the police, I mean, you don't have to do that, right?
Well, absolutely. But everybody knows that there are ways of getting around not having permission. And, it's all over the place.
Okay.
So
do you support the police cameras?
I do. So with everything, there's going to be a give and a take kind of mm-hmm. with that. So I support them because I get sick of hearing, oh, well, that film didn't show the whole thing. Well, then why weren't you wearing a camera so we could see the whole thing, officer? Why are you fighting my ability to see the whole thing?
Those are all good points.
If you want the full picture, then by God, you ought to provide the full picture, shouldn't you?
How do you suggest if we remove the on-off buttons from these cameras, when a police officer goes to the bathroom during his shift, how do we handle that?
That was actually another problem I was gonna bring up.
It's a valid question.
Because I didn't want people watching me go to the restroom.
Exactly.
I would think it'd be just looking at the front of a urinal, right?
Yeah.
Or the front
door
of a stall.
Maybe he has a really big penis and he looks down. I mean, come on.
Don't do that.
Absolutely. What if somebody else in there's got a real big one? I don't want to embarrass myself. Come on.
I can see how it might be an issue. It's not going to be mounted to your forehead.
That's true.
It's
yeah.
not to your
Although
chest.
There are some, though, right? Aren't there some that are like ear kind of
yes.
mounted cameras?
There are, yeah.
There are ear, there are glasses, there are buttons. I usually used a button cam because, then you didn't really see that it was recording. In fact, in the private sector, I use a button cam all the time. Okay. So that way it's kind of just...
What are you doing now? You got blown out of your most recent position with a police department. What are you up to these days?
So I maintained a part-time private security job so that, you know, and they're a good company, so I can kind of move on and off of part-time and full-time. So that's, I just went straight back to doing that until the next thing comes up. So.
Right on. Straight Razor, anything else you want to share tonight?
No, gentlemen, y'all have a good one.
Thanks for the call. I appreciate it. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Let's talk to Andy in Arkansas. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Andy.
Hey,
whoa, way too loud, way too loud. Can you back off your phone by like an inch or 2 inches or something?
2 inches, just a second.
Yeah, it was really like blown out, hard to really understand. Do we have you now, Andy?
No, not really.
No, you sound too far off. I'm telling you what, I'm going to put you on hold here. We'll see if the board op can work with you on the technical difficulties. Vincent in Montana, you're on Free Talk Live, listening in the Bozeman area.
Hey, evening, gentlemen.
Welcome, sir. Go ahead.
How do we prevent officer misbehavior and abuse? Well, what we have to do is we have to turn them back into peace officers.
Let's talk about that. Stand by. I like what you're saying so far. I like the idea of a peace officer. I want to give you a chance to get your thoughts out. So hang on, Vincent. We'll bring you back. 855-450-FREE. Peace officers. What is a peace officer? Do we have peace officers these days, or do we have law enforcement officers? And what's the difference? Maybe Vincent will tell us coming up. It's Free Talk Live. You can join us.
More and more people are discovering the incredible benefits of alkalizing the body, and there's no better product for it than AlkaVision Plasma pH Drops. Packed with a powerful combination of the most alkaline minerals and compounds, just a few drops in water will rid your body of harmful waste and give you more vibrance and vigor than you've had in years. Now buy two bottles and get $10 off your order. Call 800-518-7615 or visit alkavision.com. Alkalize your body. Supercharge your health at alkavision.com.
Virtually anyone can hack your cell phone and track your calls, your texts, your emails, your every movement, but only if they can detect a signal. Stay one step ahead of hackers and Big Brother with a Blockit Pocket, a custom-made pocket infused with pure silver that creates a complete Faraday enclosure for your cell phone. For free shipping to the Lower 48, visit blockitpocket.com or call 888-315-9618, blockitpocket.com, enhancing health and privacy.
Hi, I'm Daryl W. Perry, and I need your help to give away my newest book. Yes, you heard that right. I want to give away my newest book, A Rebel's Journey. The book describes my path to the ideas of liberty, which began as a search for traditional values. I will only give away the book if I reach my fundraising goal of $2,500.
But wait, there's more!
If you donate, not only can you get the ebook and the audiobook for free, but you can get bonus audio content, including interviews with Jeffrey Tucker, Lynn Ulbricht, Ben Stone, Gardner Goldsmith, and Stephen Kinsella. Or you can get a signed copy of the paperback book and more. Your donation will serve to replace the profits I would have earned through a more traditional publication of the book. The funds raised will allow me to get the book into the hands of more people and to promote the book to a wider audience. To find out more about the book or to donate, visit arebelsjourney.com.
Are you tired of governments around the world killing innocent people? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin is money that cannot be inflated or controlled by any state. By continuing to use their money, you're perpetuating the killing. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available to you now. Learn it, use it, spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. It's weusecoins.com. The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Following reports of a newly posted job listing at area marketing firm Swenson Digital, The Onion spoke to a few of the 1,400 applicants who claim they are, quote, absolutely perfect for this position.
When I first saw this opening, I knew it was right for me.
I've got tons of experience. I've got all the skills they're looking for.
If you look at my resume, I've got everything they're looking for. I mean, I've held similar jobs like this in the past. I'm extremely driven. I really think this is going to work out.
I've got a BA in marketing, which the posting said was recommended, so I think that'll bode really well for me. I've had plenty of team experience, and I think that would stand out. Not to mention the fact that I'm great with
web design and HTML, and pretty proficient with Excel and PowerPoint. Also, I think the culture is
very me, you know? I think I'd fit in well with the other employees. I also think I had a great resume
and cover letter. I think as soon as they interview me, they'll see I'm the perfect candidate.
As of this video's release, Swenson Digital had extended a job offer to an applicant who happens to be a friend of the boss's son.
This is the Onion News Network.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. We'll continue here with your calls about whatever's on your mind at 855-450-FREE. We also have Skype. You can Skype into the program here at Skype username lrn.fm. If you want to Skype us, you do need to send a contact request to us first. Now, again, username's lrn.fm. You send that request. We notice it come in, get approved. Once you're approved, you're good to go to call us on Skype from that point forward. So, again, you can join us at Skype username lrn.fm or toll free at 855-450-FREE. We will talk to you about anything. Body cameras with the police has been the overarching topic of discussion throughout tonight, but we've also touched on immigration as well. And so, again, you can go anywhere you like here. Joining you in the studio tonight, you have me, Ian.
And Virgil Viduva.
And Mark.
Virgil's here, courtesy of truthvoice.com. Great website, always good content that I see coming across my news feeds and things like that. So thanks for doing whatever amount of effort you're putting in over there. I
Thank you.
Fair amount of it. So we're going to continue with your calls and thoughts. But first, Mark, we've got pretty exciting news.
Yeah.
Because I have talked about purse on the air on Free Talk Live in the past. And then, lo and behold, the CEO of Purse sent us an email, and apparently he's a listener of Free Talk Live. Purse is
nice to know the power of radio, isn't it?
Purse is an amazing, like, and I was saying things that were great about Purse before he happened to email, right? Like, I got on talking about my experience using this system that allows you to spend your Bitcoin and get something like 20% off over at Amazon. You actually get to choose. You can get less than 20 if you want, but I usually get at least 20, if not 25% off of my purchases at Amazon.
Imagine this for a second. People buy things on Amazon all the time, and probably people would buy a lot more things on Amazon if they could get 20 to 25% off of their purchases. This is huge. And it's not something that's going to last forever, because once everybody figures it out, you know, then the demand will be higher.
Does it work with Amazon Prime?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Fantastic. Yeah.
We're both Prime.
So, well, what happens is you basically select the item you want on Amazon, whatever it is, or items, and you put it on your Amazon wish list. You then go to purse.freetalklive.com, and you're going to have to sign up if you've not signed up before. In fact, if you have signed up before and you sign up again with a different email address, that would help us out a lot. But purse.freetalklive.com, you get signed up, and then when you're in the system, you can then import your Amazon wish list into Purse, and it, you know, it sees all the items that are on there and shows you each of those items and says, all right, well, what discount do you want? And you get a little slider, and you can slide that thing all the way on up to, I think, something like 25% when you get started. Usually with Purse, they then sort of open up larger percentages as you become a larger customer. You know, you keep buying things on Purse, they open up your access. Like my account, I can get up to 50% off. Now, I've never gotten that much. I've only tried it once and it hasn't gone anywhere. So, you know, basically what's happening is you're bidding in a marketplace with other people who want to buy that the Bitcoin from you. So you can't use Purse and pay with cash for Amazon. You have to use your Bitcoin. So this is a killer app, in my opinion, for Bitcoin, because a lot of people will say, well, I got this Bitcoin, but I don't want to spend it. Why would I want to spend Bitcoin when I could spend all this cash, these Federal Reserve notes? If I have to pay X in Federal Reserve notes and X in Bitcoin, I'm going to hold the Bitcoin because I hope the Bitcoin's going to go up in value over time.
Right? Everybody who's ever Bitcoin, what are you going to do with that? You can get 20 to 25% off your Amazon purchases. That's what you can do with it.
Yeah. Yeah. And it's not a can thing. I haven't ever had an item that I put at 25% not go.
Wow.
Like within 24 hours or so. Now, you have to be a little patient with the higher percentages. But even Purse has a Purse Instant feature where you don't have to be patient. You just get like, I don't think it's like 5% or 8%. I've never used the instant feature because I want 25% off and I'm willing to wait for it.
24 hours.
And it works really, really well. So go and try it out. Purse.freetalklive.com. I'm so excited they're actually officially on board.
Yeah, I'm gonna go sign up for it tonight. Honestly,
I've saved. It's cool because I actually count how many items you've purchased and how much you've saved. Like, had you bought those items, which you would have bought anyway, likely at Amazon.
Yeah, we use Amazon for everything.
How much would you have saved? It shows you that I've saved nearly $500 on you know 15 or 20 transactions.
Don't wait until you make the purchase. Go sign up now at purse.freetalklive.com. Yep. Don't even wait until you get the bitcoins. Just go sign up now at purse.freetalklive.com.
Well, the other thing Purse does is they'll let you buy bitcoins too. So that's the other side of Purse, is if you need to buy bitcoins, you don't want to go through, you know, checks and security checks and things like that, then you can buy them with your credit cards through Purse. You'll pay a premium, but that's the other thing they do. So if you want to save big, like 20, 25% on Amazon, go to purse.freetalklive.com and get started tonight. All right, let's go to your calls and thoughts here. We've got, we were on with Vincent, actually, in Montana, and he had begun talking about the idea of a peace officer. Vincent, can you define what that is for our listeners who might not be familiar?
Well, yeah, it's easy. A peace officer had carried a performance bond in the old days. They used to have to take out a personal bond that would guarantee the performance of their oath. And this was common up until the 70s. And then, for some reason, the insurance companies started covering these departments with overlapping blanket insurance policies, and the bonding was eliminated, even though, in the case of Montana, the bonding laws are all still on the books, but they inserted one word, except, for law enforcement officers, and they eliminated the bonding with one word. And replaced it with insurance. Now, bonding and insurance are not the same thing. When you hire a plumber, a lot of times they'll say they're both bonded and insured. Well, why would they need to be both? Because they're different. Insurance covers property loss, while bonding guarantees performance.
Interesting. Bonding,
yeah, I guess it does.
If a cop is bonded, he has skin in the game. In other words, if he misbehaves, that money is coming out of his personal pocket and fortune. He can literally indebt himself with a bad performance. So it causes them to have skin in the game, and it causes them to watch their behavior because they're going to be held accountable. You know, they call them peace officers because they hold an office. What we have today is law enforcement agents. I believe that they're no longer officers, because if you look at the definition of an office is created by law and sworn to and it entered with an oath. Well, in the old days, a peace officer was bonded to his oath. In other words, you had to take out the bond in order to take the oath.
Interesting.
And that's no longer the case. Now these are just human resource employees that are covered by insurance policies, and the premium on the insurance has already been paid up front, already been paid and lost. They can't lose any more money. They're only covered to the limits of the insurance policy. So there's nothing in that insurance policy to keep that officer from misbehaving and keep the departments from just handing it off to the insurance company and writing it off.
Well, plus, if we had
a bad behavior.
Yes, excellent thoughts there. I really appreciate your call tonight, Vincent. Thanks for hanging on to tell us about that. And the other thing with a peace officer is the goal of a peace officer is to restore and protect peace, as opposed to a law enforcement officer whose goal is to enforce all these arbitrary edicts that have been handed down by various different states and federal legislators over the years. They're, you know, sometimes they can feel very, very robot-like in their enforcement of these laws. And it doesn't matter to them whether they're hurting people or not. It's the law. I'm just doing my job.
So RoboCop would be a great example
of an automaton.
Yeah. A law enforcement officer.
And unfortunately, there's that possibility that it won't be long before we see robot law enforcement officers,
right,
which, you know, you're not going to be able to reason with them. and you want your officers with no discretion, Mark? Well, that's likely when you're going to get that.
When I say I want officers with no discretion, I want to end the drug war.
Okay,
I want to end victimless crimes and frivolous things. I think that there should be far fewer laws, but the ones that we have should be better enforced.
So you are welcome to share your thoughts here tonight. And by the way, we are going to be live kicking the show off tomorrow from Porkfest, live in person for 7 nights here on Free Talk Live. And we'll look forward to seeing a lot of our listeners out there. Porkfest.com is where you can go to learn more about what we're going to be doing. So if you don't get in tonight, you can still join us during Porkfest week. We'll still be able to take your phone calls. Skype's going to be off the table, but we'll still be able to take your calls. We've got plenty of time for those calls. So if you're hanging on, you're coming up next. 855-450-FREE is our toll-free number. We've also got Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. We continue with a live Saturday edition of Free Talk Live in moments.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
How fast are new Allegra gel caps?
I didn't know you got a cat fast.
How strong are new Allegra gel caps?
10 more logs to go strong.
Non-drowsy Allegra gives you noticeable relief of your toughest allergy symptoms in just 1 hour. 2 times faster than Claritin, and stays strong for 24 hours. New Allegra gel caps. Nothing's faster. Nothing's stronger. Among OTC oral antihistamines, refers to first dose only. Starts working in 1 hour. Use only as directed. Visit Allegra.com.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Now a twice-as-nice Twin Kit special offer from Complete H2O Minerals for all GCN listeners. Get a Complete H2O Minerals Twin Kit with 33 different minerals, vitamins, and amino acids all in a liquid form. Enough for 2 people for 1 month. Regular price $89.95, but now Complete H2O Minerals is offering the Twin Kit for $69.95. And all GCN listeners receive a bonus 16-ounce bottle of Ionic Silver absolutely free with free shipping. A $120 total value. Hurry, limited time offer. Call 803-794-4767 or click CompleteH2OMinerals.com.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. If you're not on hold already, we're probably not going to be able to get to your call, so I will try not to give out the phone number, even though I tend to do it out of habit. With you in the studio tonight, it's Ian.
Virgil Viduva.
And Mark.
Virgil's here, courtesy of truthvoice.com, and you are hopefully courtesy of wherever you are. We're going to go to your phone calls here in moments. Also want to encourage you to visit freetalklive.com. Please enjoy the features that you'll find there, and don't forget to join us in real life at the Porcupine Freedom Festival. It's coming up here starting tomorrow and runs for an entire week. We'll be broadcasting live every single night, so if you can't make it out, you'll get a taste, a little flavor of what it's like to be at the Porcupine Freedom Festival, because we'll be interviewing all kinds of wonderful folks who are going to be there, and they always have interesting things to talk about. And of course, we'll take your calls about anything during that time. All right, back to the phones and the fun. Let's go first to Brandon, listening in Alabama. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Brandon.
Hey, guys. How are we doing this evening?
Welcome, sir. Go ahead with your thoughts.
Okay. First off, I just want to say I listen to you guys pretty regularly, and while I pretty much disagree with about 95% of what you say, I do understand that you guys are smart fellas. You're well-spoken, you know, you're passionate in your beliefs, and I have a lot of respect for that. It takes a lot of courage to put that out there, especially on a radio show.
Thanks.
I guess my question I've always had since I began listening to you guys is, and I understand there's a lot of things wrong in our country, but outside of moving to Walden, what solutions are you offering that's gonna make a real lasting change? The United States I grew up in, the United States that I live in, unfortunately, is dictated a lot by money. So if you really wanted to make a huge change, or the way the government oversees everybody, why not, try to become billionaires, that you could actually do that? I mean,
I'm trying that.
Yeah, who's not trying to do that?
Yeah, I'd love that very much. But the thing is in order to, in radio, we might be able to make more money if we decided to take a more mainstream approach to things.
You
right?
mean compromise your principles?
Yeah, well, I mean, yeah. Take a mainstream approach.
Well, that's not exactly fair. Because I've heard you guys accuse the government of, fear mongering as a tactic, and I gotta call it like I see it, and some of you guys' sponsors use fear the same way, just to your
no advantage. Doubt.
Oh, yeah. For one, what you need to understand is the way our sponsorships work is that the people that you hear in the commercials aren't necessarily who our sponsors are. We don't get dollars and cents from everybody who you hear on the ads. And that's true for all talk radio.
Purse is a sponsor, but not everything that you hear coming out of your speakers on your radio is necessarily a sponsor directly. It might be a sponsor of the radio station. It might
Which
be a sponsor
great.
Of our network.
Sure.
But I think sure. his point is valid here, that there are absolutely companies out there who advertise based on fear. There's no doubt about it. It's an effective method
it
of
works.
Advertising. The difference, of course, being that you still ultimately have the choice to deal with that company. And with the government, you don't have a choice. Right. They're going to take
the
your money.
The state works on...
That brings me back to my original point, is that you guys do have a choice. And if you're, I certainly wouldn't want you to leave, because I really enjoy your program. But if you're this disappointed or this upset with your country, then move.
Virgil, how do you answer that as somebody who actually isn't from here originally?
Yeah.
The old "if you don't like it, leave" objection.
No, I'm not going to leave. I came from another country. I spent most of my life in communist Romania. And I came here because this place is actually more free than many other places in the world.
Is it getting to be more or less?
No. It was 20 years ago. Now it's actually getting back to the way Romania was when I was back there. So the United States is actually getting worse as we speak.
But you've left one country. Why don't you leave this one?
No, no. I'm not going to abdicate my ability to, make change, to promote change. Just because I have a different opinion from someone and because we disagree on how we go about promoting change, it doesn't mean I need to leave.
Yeah, also...
No. I don't want you to misunderstand. I'm not telling you to leave. I'm just...
saying why not?
If I'm unhappy at a job, because that's none of my business. That's your business.
Right. I'll answer it. I absolutely agree. If you aren't in the country that you're that you think you're going to be happiest in, you really should move to the country you should be happiest in,
there
right?
You go, sure.
Like that's
exactly.
You need to understand that we did, right? Like we picked up and moved from Florida to move to New Hampshire for the Free State Project to hang around other libertarians. We continue to point out the foibles of the United States as it continues to slide down the lists of freest countries in the world. But it is not moved out of the top 20. I mean, there's opportunity costs for moving. You know, it costs money to pick up and move your life. And the United States is still a great place to earn money. Now, as the government gets bigger and more intrusive, that will become less and less likely. If I was a young man, I'd say Southeast Asia, young man. But today, right. You know, I'm 44 years old. I'm relatively established, and this is the life I want to live. But, you know, ultimately, yeah, if there was a country that I thought I was going to get more freedom by moving to, I would. But currently, there's a place called Liberland. It's between Serbia and Croatia, and it's a place that's 3 square miles of unclaimed, what they call terra nullia. It is legally unclaimed by any country, and they're beginning to attempt to create a country there. And Croatia is attempting to stop them from creating a country there. Why? Because the state is rapacious. It doesn't matter whether that
they're
state...
trying to leave, right?
Right.
Those people
right.
are trying.
I'm not against America, dude. I just happen to be in America. I'm against the concept of a monopoly organization claiming the right to rule
a
piece
again,
of land.
Again,
I'm against kings, too.
Understand me. I'm not saying get the heck out.
No. I'm answering your question.
I appreciate your idea. Yes, sir. I just, again...
Where would I go? Let me ask the question.
Well, you're running out. I mean, that's the thing. I mean, look, man, utopia is not going to happen.
Yep.
And nobody expects that to happen, Brandon.
I just want forward progress.
I'm asking for progress. I don't feel like it's unreasonable for me to ask that my fellow humans not threaten me. If I don't want to go along with their right. program, whatever their idea is, they think it's great, and they want to threaten me to force me to go along with funding their idea. Don't you agree that that shouldn't happen, that I shouldn't be threatened?
Absolutely. That should have been, or it used to be the basic bedrock of our nation.
Well, then it sounds like we agree on more than 5% here. I mean, it sounds like, you know,
hey,
we're on the same page.
I was being generous with the 5%.
I mean, it sounds like we agree on a lot. I mean, it sounds like you said we disagreed on 95%. You and I agree on the bedrock here.
I'm not into labels, but you're definitely on a certain spectrum of thinking that I agree with partial or some of the things that you guys say. And again, guys, I'm not hating on
Brandon,
you.
Brandon, I appreciate it, man. I never felt like you were hating on me.
I never did either. I was really trying to answer the question.
We're just having a conversation, and I want to tell you, I appreciate you calling and talking to us, and thank you again for making that. I want to see if I can sneak some other folks in here. Let's go to Matt in New Jersey, listening via TuneIn. Hello, Matt. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Virgil, and Mark.
Hi. Thanks for taking my call tonight.
Go ahead quickly, if you can.
Yeah, I find myself in a really awful predicament. I wanted to get you guys' opinion. What do you do if you have a family member who is addicted to drugs, say heroin, and they start stealing from your mom? And you don't want to call the police because you know that just brings a terrible problem for them. What would you do instead?
I would make sure they don't have a key to mom's house first and foremost.
What if they've already stolen some valuable jewelry and sold it at a pawn shop?
It's gone.
The police aren't going to get it back.
Well, probably not. Yeah, probably not going
to
get that back.
Well, if you do file a police report, there's a chance you can go to the pawn shop with the receipt and say this stuff was stolen and try and buy it back.
Your relative would also get arrested if you do that.
Well, the relative stole. I mean, as far as I'm concerned, once a person steps over...
But the idea is this is from... They're stealing from families, so should you bend a little bit with the family rather than... going straight to the
police. The question you have to ask yourself is the consequences. I don't care what happens to this relative at this point. The consequences for you and your family, which one's worse? Your relative being incarcerated and having to deal with whatever that, you know, those consequences are. Remember, it's going to be harder for them to get a job in the future, and, or just going and buying the jewelry back.
Well, I think the question was
no alternative.
Yeah, I think their question was what in between there is there, and I think there are some other options, right?
Like
you can sit down and talk with your loved one and say, look, you know, you're having this issue. We're willing to help you by getting you into some sort of a treatment and see if they're willing to check themselves into that. Odds are good they won't be interested in that. But at least you could present that to them as an option, as like, hey, you know, we care about you. Hey, we don't want to go to the police. How about you start working and making payments to your mom and try to pay off the lost value from the things that you stole? Either way, you're dealing with a drug addict who can't be trusted. And thank you, Matt. I appreciate hearing from you tonight. I wish we had more time to discuss it, but we're out of time. Ultimately, you don't want to give them access to the house. Get rid of their key, change the locks if you have to, and keep them at arm's length. See you tomorrow.
Well, since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Off the Air Live is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, June 20th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.10 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,200 per ounce, and according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $244. Antiwar.com reports the Yemen peace talks being held in Geneva effectively ended yesterday with the announcement that the pro-Saudi Hadi faction will withdraw from the talks and return to exile in Saudi Arabia, which is presently attacking Yemen with the goal of reinstalling them as the government. The talks began inauspiciously Monday with the demands from the Hadi faction that the Houthis surrender all cities in the country as a condition for discussing an end to the Saudi strikes. Yemeni Foreign Minister Riyad Yassin complained that the Houthis did not comply with any of their demands. It is unsurprising that the talks are collapsing at this point, as a press conference on Thursday by the Houthis ended in fistfights when the Hadi faction attacked them, throwing shoes at the delegate addressing the assembled media. The Saudis never really stopped their airstrikes during the talk and continued with the talks yesterday after the lack of resolution. UN officials expressed disappointment in the process, noting the Hadi and Houthi factions never even sat down at the same table during the 5 days and insisted the UN transfer messages back and forth. The only time they were even in the same room was during Thursday's brawl. For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports the former CEO of a company that sells and operates red light cameras told a judge she bribed officials in Cincinnati and Columbus, Ohio to secure and maintain contracts with the cities. Karen Finley of Cave Creek, Arizona pled guilty Friday in U.S. District Court in the Southern District of Ohio to conspiracy to commit federal programs bribery and honest services wire and mail fraud. Between 2005 and 2013, Finley was CEO of Redflex Traffic Systems, a company that sets up cameras at intersections to snap photos of vehicles running red lights. She admitted she participated in a scheme in which the company made campaign contributions to elected officials in the two cities in exchange for securing red light camera contracts with the municipalities. Additionally, the company concealed the contributions through invoices labeling the payments as being for consulting services to a third party who then made the contributions. Columbus City Council member and current mayoral candidate Andrew Ginther is one of those officials alleged to have received a campaign contribution from Redflex Traffic Systems. Ginther released a statement Friday denying the claims. He said, "I had absolutely no knowledge of these activities and did not take part in them. While I am not subject of the inquiry, I have been asked to provide records that may help the investigation into Redflex. I've fully cooperated and will continue to assist in bringing these people to justice. In light of these charges, I have asked City Attorney Rick Pfeiffer to conduct an investigation into any current contracts between the city and Redflex." The U.S. Department of Justice said that Finley will be sentenced at a future date.
You can support FPP Radio by joining the Fans program. Fans are friends, allies, and numerary supporters. Fans help FPP afford to produce more original content. You can join the Fans program for as little as $3 per month or any amount of Bitcoin per month, thanks to the recurring payment options provided by Coinbase. To learn more or to join the Fans program, visit fans.fppradio.com. That's fans.fppradio.com.
Reuters reports a state board revoked the license of a former U.S. Army doctor on Friday, finding that he plied students with hypnotic drugs during battlefield trauma training and performed dangerous procedures, including intentionally inducing shock. The doctor, John Henry Hagman, was cited for training he provided in 2012 and 2013 in Virginia, North Carolina, Colorado, and Great Britain. Students testified on Friday that Hagman also performed penile nerve blocks and instructed them to insert catheters into one another's genitals. Assistant Attorney General Frank Pedrotti told the Virginia Board of Medicine, "The evidence is so overwhelming and so bizarre as to almost shock the conscience of a prosecutor who's been doing this for 26 years. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
A heroic broken sewage pipe floods Congress with waste. Johnson & Johnson introduces new leave-in Q-tips. This Thursday, local youth Andrew Robillard told reporters he had no idea why he couldn't wear his Iron Man costume to his grandfather's funeral. Robillard, whose grandfather passed away this week after complications from a stroke, vented his frustration to reporters and noted that his grandpa, quote,